back at the Atlanta, Georgia World Congress Center for the boat show. Here's the 2024 Atlanta Boat Show at the Atlanta, Georgia World Congress Center. And I'm sure they're going to have a lot more boats this time than last time, because last time they had a ton of boats. I'm sure they'll have a lot of boats this time. So here's a Chaparral. Look at this monster. So looks like they have a booth here. This is all the Chaparral booth here. They have huge canopy roofs on them. And of course they have these platform step decks so you can get inside them. You could walk on them too, which is really cool. They got cup holders all around. And there's a sales rep showing it to a few potential customers who might want to buy it. Let's see the information on it. How are you? And it looks like, I think you got to take your shoes off in order to climb inside so you don't have any foreign material once you step on or step in. Let's see what this is. Wow. This looks really cool. Here's some information on it. Volvo V8. Volvo doesn't really make that many V8 engines that much anymore.
Oh, it's awesome. Let me tell you, I have one. I own it. I'm going to pass you by.
Oh, that's all right. Yeah. Thank you. And here's the interior where the driver's seat is. It's on this side, on the right-hand side. It's got two computer screens here. Looks like this one is for the GPS, and this one is your tachometer and speedometer. Throttle control right here on this side. The driver's seat itself is swivel, so you can swivel around 360 degrees. Different buttons and switches on here. Passenger side compartment here, SS, that's interesting. There's a little cubby holder here, speaker, swivel passenger seat, bench seating in the rear, that's really cool. A lot of these boats are like that. These are basically cruisers or luxury speed boats, if you will. And here is the front or the bow with extra bench seating here. Very comfy. Look at all that leather. And it's got an armrest here. That's kind of cool. And it folds up like this. That's pretty cool for extra comfort. It's got some grab handlebars on both sides too for extra safety. And the whole view of the boat show from here, what a great view. They got Yamaha. They got jet skis too. They got all kinds of boats on display here. I'm gonna go right back outside. Look at more of these Chaparrals over here. Another Chaparral. This one's got a slightly different interior color. White canopy roof, whereas that one has a black canopy roof. Similar style boat. And again, we got to be careful stepping in. And these seats are a little bit wider. I like the wider seats. Gives you extra comfort. Oh, wow. It's got like an extra cover on there.
Sky shade.
A sky shade. So that's what that is. Sky shade. That's cool. And here it's two computer screens right here. They're made by Simrad. Never heard of Simrad before. And it looks like here's a speaker right here on its canopy roof. It's got two of these on either side. I definitely like the wider seats. That's always a good touch. And here's another Chaparral. This one's got a slightly skinnier canopy. It's not a roof. It's more like a roll bar, I think. Probably a roll bar or a roll cage. I'm going to step right up here. Careful here. There's its two Simrad computer screens right there. Narrower seat than in the other one right next to me. And this one's got a door. So the door can swing open. I think it could swing open or so. I think it's probably locked, but yeah, you can probably swing it open and stuff. And I think you pull this or something. It must be locked right now, but I think it gives you an idea of that. So you can gain access right here. Another chaparral, that's called the Surf. It's got another canopy roof on that one. Another good view of here. There's also Honda Marine. They make really good engines as well. And I like the color of this one. This one was also here last year. Looks like a kind of like a dark beige or something. Wow, look at that giant bench seat cover where the engine is. I like that. Wow. I do like the look of this one. This one looks really cool. Here's more information on this one. Let's see. Also with a Volvo engine. Volvo V8. And it's got a giant computer screen, one single screen instead of two screens. That actually does look pretty cool. I like how that looks. Very luxurious, very sweet looking. And it's got a massive LED strip light right here on the seating in the front of the bow. That looks really neat. It's a blue color. I think you can order that in different colors, I don't know for sure. But over there, there's a jet ski. I think it's a Yamaha VX, I think. Those are cool. There's a Yamaha big boat next to it, 255X. Luxury cruiser. Oh, and those ones look pretty cool too. I'll check both those out. Yeah, these chaparrals, they're pretty neat. They're all about luxury, that's for sure. And here's a pontoon boat. This is a Premier PTX. And look at this. It's got a water slide on its roof. That's really cool. So you can climb up that ladder right there at the rear and slide down that water slide on the roof if you so desire, which is pretty cool. And it looks like you can rent this too. Huh. And it's part of the Carefree Boat Club. It's pretty neat. There's some information on here. Benefits of the Carefree Boat Club. This one's got a Honda engine with VTEC. Look at that. VTEC 250. Wow. Not only do Honda cars have VTEC, but Honda boats can have VTEC too. VTEC kicked in, yo. Wow. That's hilarious. And another chaparral. A lot of chaparrals over here. A little roll bar on the top. And here is the engine. It's a Volvo Penta 300 V8. I mean, Volvo did make a few V8 engines, but they don't make as many now for automotive use, but they're mostly for marine use like this, which is interesting. But others use Ford or Chevrolet. Some even can use Hemis also, depending on, you know, the application and what they desire. But yeah, that gives you a good little perspective on that. Here's more pontoon boats over here. Whoa, 160 grand for this monster. This one's got a V10. It's probably the Ford V10, the Triton 6.8 liter, I think. Wow, what a monster this is. And it's a Godfrey. Godfrey is one of the leaders in pontoon boat makers. Wow. Look at that monster. Oh, it's a 5.7 liter V10. It's probably not a Ford V10. It's a Mercury. But wow. 5.7 liter V10. That's like... I mean, that's like the same size as the Porsche Carrera GT's V10, but a lot more horsepower. It's called the Verado. I bet it sounds really good. And here's these staircases, so you can get it up inside it here. I'm going to climb up inside now. I'm guessing this is carpeting of some kind. Yeah, that's pretty cool. All kinds of bench seating all around. Here's a little small table or desk with little cup holders in it. Swivel passenger seat here with the swivel driver seat on this side with a huge computer screen right there on the center console on the driver's area. Sampan, that's probably what it's called. And here's a little cup holder table desk right here at the rear with extra bench seating. That looks beautiful. There's where that monster V10 engine is right there. Wow, V10 powered boat. That's interesting. That definitely has to sound good to make a lot of torque, because that's what the V10 is named for. Wow. Hard to believe a pontoon boat of all things can also have a V10, right? That's crazy. Gonna crawl down these steps here. Another pontoon boat, another Godfrey. Let's see what this is here. Oh, a little bit of a different color in this one. Oh, and here's the door. So you can literally step in and out of it like this. Door is open. I like the dark black leather accents in here. That looks really good in my opinion. Doesn't have that table like in that one over there, but a similar layout here in the driver's seat. Whoa, look at that. Got an electronic instrument cluster computer, complete with a rear view camera. That looks really cool. GPS computer over there on the right hand side of the steering wheel. Wow. It's definitely more high tech than a car, that's for sure. Wow, boats these days are extremely high tech and very sophisticated. I mean, this basically rivals that of your everyday luxury car. Wow, that's insane. I'm not gonna lie, this actually does look pretty good. Got a huge canopy roof on top, complete with speakers, and a canopy cover as well. The engine is covered right back here as well. And there are Suzuki engines right over there. So these are all the Godfrey pontoon boats over here. As I mentioned, Godfrey is a leader in pontoon boat manufacturing. I like that red one. Let's see what this one is. I'll climb up on inside here. Okay, wow. Door is open right here. Cup holders right here on the front bench seat. That's pretty cool. And it's a long buoy, that's for sure. Also, it's a table with cup holders at the rear. That looks really neat. Smaller screen on the driver's seat. Also has a few analog instruments, such as the RPM tachometer and the speedometer. Pretty basic and simple. I do like that. If you want to go minimal. Oh, look at that. There's LED lighting inside the cup holders. Now that's pretty cool looking. It's got a Mercury engine right back here. 400. It's probably the same V10 as in the other one that I just saw. And look at that over there. Progressive Insurance made their own jet ski. Wow, that's funny looking. And I wonder what these are. Those are from Mountain Motorsports. I'm guessing those are Sea-Doos. Let's see what those are. But yeah, Godfrey makes a lot of luxurious pontoon boats. They are huge and massive and could be configured in almost any configuration. Wow, they got a massive selection of pontoon boats. 29-inch impact triple tube tri-tune. So this one's called the tri-tune, hence why it's got three pontoons on it, as you can see. Yeah, see, that's a tri-tune, so it's got three pontoons on it. Three of these tubes on it. That's pretty neat. It also has either a 61-gallon tank or a 121-gallon tank for two engines. You can have the two engines in this monster, which is insane. In fact, let's go ahead and check this out. Okay. I like this, the leather stitching right there. Pretty neat looking pattern. Blue LED lighting inside the cup holders. Is that like an aqua blue of some kind? I think it is. Swivel seats, both passenger and driver. And look at that, it already comes with an iPhone holder and charger, complete. How about that? Now that's cool. Very useful when out on the water, because everyone has an iPhone these days, and it really helps. Wow, that looks really cool. There's the GPS right there on the center console. On the instrument cluster. Oh, wait a minute, what's this? There's no engine in here. Same in this one. Looks like some of these engines have been removed. In fact, you can see that right over there. So here's a cutaway engine that's actually been torn apart for both demonstration purposes and repairs. So now we're gonna go ahead and climb down from this one here so we can actually see how this engine looks and how you work on it as well. So here's a Yamaha 350 V8 that's been torn apart for maintenance and repairs. And this shows you the inner workings of these engines and how you work on them. I love your shirt, by the way. Oh yeah, I love it. Let's see.
How are you guys doing today?
Good, sir. How are you?
Fine. You have any questions? Anything I can help you with?
So is this for demonstration purposes, or is this for maintenance or repairs, or does this try to teach you how to work on it, or what?
Are you talking about the motor, or you're talking about the display?
This one here, this complete engine.
This motor is basically here just to show people how the insides of it work.
I do like that, you know. That really that really fascinates me.
Great.
I really like that. Plus, it shows you all the inner workings on there and how it all works.
That's the whole concept behind it. That's why it's cut out.
That's right. And also, how easy or difficult is it to work on this? If you were to do any repairs on it or any of that yourself?
Well, of course, it's going to depend upon the repair.
Uh-huh.
It's not bad. The normal service is fairly simple and straightforward.
Oh, wow.
Oil change and that sort of thing.
Okay.
If you're looking at taking the lower unit apart,
yeah,
it's a little bit more involved.
Okay.
There are special tools that go along with it.
Wow.
If you're doing work on the engine, if you know you have a problem, you have to plug a laptop into it.
Oh, and tune it.
To find out what the problem may be, and then from that point, you know where to go.
That's cool. You know, I really like that. And my late uncle used to work on boats like this for a living, but he passed away a while back. So You know, he used to basically work on one of our boats that we had back at our lake house, and you know, he used to fix a lot of things that we had there, but since he passed, you know, we haven't really been there that much, unfortunately, so we had to get rid of our boats and stuff.
Oh, sorry to hear that.
I know. He was great. I mean, he basically did a lot of this. He was basically an outdoorsman. He did a lot of hunting and fishing and working on boats, and that was his thing. That was his gig.
How about that?
Yeah. And so, this really, you know, brings me back memories of my late uncle. It really does.
Glad to hear that.
And now, this is a V8, correct?
That is correct.
I love that. Now, how many liters or cubic inches is this? What's the size of it?
5.3 liters.
Oh, so it's a Chevrolet engine?
No.
Oh, it's not?
It's built by Yamaha, but the displacement is 5.3 liters.
Oh, wow. That's interesting. Now, where is this whole thing made?
The motors are made in Japan.
Wow.
And then they're shipped over to the U.S.
Interesting. Huh. Wow. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Huh. Wow. I've seen a few Yamaha V8s, but not that much. Although I do know they helped make the V10 for the Lexus LFA supercar. Now,
absolutely,
that's a monster.
Yamaha and Toyota do a lot of combined products.
That they do, yeah. That they definitely do.
Yeah.
But a 5.3 liter Yamaha V8, I'd like to see how that compares to a 5.3 liter Chevrolet LS V8.
Two completely different animals.
Oh, yeah. Two completely different ones, that's for sure.
Well, because the outboard motor is built specifically for higher RPMs.
Ah, okay.
Because normally it's going to run between 3,500 and 5,800 RPMs.
Wow.
Where the Chevrolet, you know, 2,500 to 3,000.
Yeah, because that's where all the low-end torque is.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like Apple.
Wow.
And I'm great. How are you?
Okay. This is really neat. I really like how this is all cut away and stuff, so it gives you all the inner workings of this. And
absolutely.
And I really like how this looks, and this actually shows you where all the propeller shafts meet. That's really, really cool.
I'm glad you're enjoying it.
And got the differential gears right there to distribute the torque.
Yeah, that is forward and reverse gear.
Wow, that's cool. I like that. That is cool. And how fast can this typically go? And how much horsepower can this make?
Well, this is a 350 horsepower engine.
Oh, wow.
And the speed it can go is all going to depend on the boat it's attached to.
Okay. Wow. I like that. Yeah.
Great.
Well, thanks for showing me around, sir.
You're
I appreciate that.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.
And what's your name, sir?
Don Smith.
Don Smith. All right. And so this is your group, Fred Shed?
Yeah. We're sponsored by the Boat Show. So
wow.
We're here to answer any questions, and we have a seminar each hour. And,
okay.
That's what we do.
I like that. Thanks for showing me, sir. I appreciate that.
Welcome.
And here's a Yamaha VX jet ski right over here. This one's really cool looking. I like the blue and red paint on there. Blue body paint with the red accents. It's from Park Marine Boating Centers, VX Deluxe. Here's some information on it. It's a three-cylinder engine, Yamaha Marine. 14 grand, I mean, that's quite a bit for a jet ski, but hey, it's actually not too bad. Wow. You can have it in either blue and red or black and green. The two different liveries on there. So Fred Shed, looks like they got all the different parts here. So, oh, look at that. These are like the shafts of these outboard motors. These are cool. And Evinrude, you gotta love Evinrude. They're legendary. Wow. Look at all this. And Progressive, too.
Wow.
I got to admit, this is impressive. And so these all came off of this, correct?
Those came off of multiple different motors.
Oh, wow. So this basically gives you an idea on how to work on these, or what?
So we teach DIY seminars on what kind of maintenance you should be doing, what kind of maintenance you might not be doing.
Okay.
As well as we teach new boater basics. So if you're new to boating, you can come over here, you can sit down.
I like that.
If you have a problem with your boat, we have a technician on site that can answer your questions.
Okay.
And it's all free and a service of the show.
I like that. Yeah, you know, working on stuff is pretty interesting, and you know, boats definitely are different to work on than cars, and there's different stuff going on, and it's pretty neat. Very sophisticated. I like it. Wow. And you got toolbox here as well. You gotta love the toolbox. That's a lot bigger than mine. I love that. Wow. And here's another engine over here. Here's the Yamaha 5.3 liter four stroke outboard V8. As you can see, it's mounted facing upwards instead of longitudinal. So it looks like it's facing upwards. And so it's all cut away, and you can see its inner workings right here. A lot of wiring goes into there as well. Looks like that's probably its fuse box or its relay, I think. And here's one with the cylinder head covered with the valve cover. And over here on this side is the cylinder head exposed with the valve cover removed. So it's a dual overhead cam. V8, it's probably got 32 valves or so. Wow. This is a lot different than a Chevrolet LS 5.3 liter V8. Wow. But for a completely different application. This one is just for boats. Although, I dare to see somebody swap this in a car. That would be insane. There's on water towing as well. Progressive Insurance, and they got a spinning wheel over there to win prizes. I can hear a funny horn going off in the background. Here's another pontoon. This one's called Grass Shack. Also a tri-tube. 74 grand.
And we got $5,000 discounts on all our boats today.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
So these are all yours, huh?
Yeah.
Wow.
We got another booth over there.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, much more juicy.
Mind if I check this out? Let's see what this is. Wow. Okay. Wow. Got the canopy roofs on them. Here's one with a roof on it already. And that looks like it's got a rack on the back with a little mat. That's pretty cool. Wow. This is like a big flat deck. That's really cool. Like a big flat bench deck where you can sit and sleep on. I really like that. I like the driver's seat layout here. That looks really cool. Looks like it's got wood grain on the instrument cluster there. That's pretty neat. GPS computer on the side of it from Garmin. Then again, swivel seat. This one's got a Suzuki engine. Right here on the rear. Yep. This one's Suzuki, and that one's Suzuki as well. Suzuki also makes motorcycles and motorcycle engines. But hey, they have a strong following in the marine world too. These ones are really neat looking. Yeah, thanks for showing me around, sir. I like that.
Hey, don't worry, we're doing the show.
Yeah, thank you. All right. Let's see. So, here's another grass shack. Whoa, 175 grand. This one's on a trailer, so it's a little bit high up. It's called the Avalon. Also a tri-tune. Trailer's pretty neat looking. You're gonna need that for hauling a monster boat like this, that's for sure. And here's another pontoon, and these ones are Honda powered. With Honda VTEC. VTEC kicked in, yo. Wow. And look at this. This one's a coach. Wow, look at that. Oh, that's a pretty neat looking driver's seat layout. Got the Simrad computer. Screen right in front of the steering wheel. Right there. Touring 63 FLC. And this one here is the 243 REC. This is the Coach FLC bed boat. Interesting name. Whereas this one is called the bar boat. This one's the RE. This is by Coach. Huh. Very interesting. Wow, look at this. Oh, it's got LEDs on the speakers right below there, and it changes colors. That's pretty cool. Wait a minute. Is it just me, or does that sound like Cardi B? I think it does. It's hilarious. Cardi B is the funniest, most hilarious rapper I've ever heard. Oh, wow. This one's got toggle switches right here on its driver console. Simrad computer in front of the driver's seat as well. I like this. This is really cool. This gives you different options to do. Whereas this one right next to this has a desk with cup holders and little bar stools on it. That's really cool. So if you're having a bite to eat out on the water, or if you're having like a mini restaurant, then this will really help. Honda VTEC in here. VTEC kicked in, yo. Same with that one. Although I doubt this will hit 8,000 RPM or more, but still, it's got VTEC. Who doesn't love VTEC? It's insane. And they got some Chevrolet trucks here on display. Interesting. Got the Colorado. It's called the Trail Boss, which is one of the top off-road trim levels. 7,000 pound towing. Okay, 29 grand, not too bad. Wow, look at the inside of this. Two digital instrument computer screens. It's a crew cab. Trail Boss logo right there. Here's its bed. That looks about the same size as a Silverado from the previous generations. More like the... It's about the same size as a square body Silverado from like the 70s and 80s, like the C10. That's how massive it is. This doesn't even look like a midsize anymore. This looks more like a full size. And here's all the towing capacities of all the Chevrolet trucks and SUV lineups. And let's see, this one has its door open here so you can see the inside of this. That looks really neat. And this one is the Traverse. And there is some Chevrolet representatives over here with these beautiful shirts. I love these. Look at that. This is Chevy Country, established 1918. Wow. Oh, good choice. Get the Silverado. Yeah, that's good. You'll love it. Especially with V8 power, you'll be going all over the place. And there's the Silverado right over here. Also, Trail Boss, I have this truck in my Forza Horizon 5 video game. It's the Z71 off-road package as well. I It's got the monster 6.2 liter V8 in here. Same size in my, as in my Corvette C7 Stingray. Sweet looking interior. It's got step sides on the bumper, so you can easily get in and out from the bed here. And as you can see, the tailgate has different functions that it can open up at, which is really neat. It can open in different ways. I think it's like a six-way or something. That's pretty neat. See, this half can also open alongside this half. And it forms, I think, an extra stepping stool or something if you want to climb in easier. It's like a multi-function tailgate. It's pretty cool. I have a Corvette C7 Stingray.
Awesome.
That's what I have. I love this display here. It's great.
Great.
Oh, yeah.
If you want to go behind the truck, I could do the light test for you.
Please, let me see. Yeah, I have a Corvette.
Oh, nice.
C7 Stingray.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So well, one of the Chevrolet reps is doing the light check on the Silverado. Whoa, that's bright. And it blinks and flashes too. Look at that.
Exactly. And as you can see over here in this demonstration, if you have the My Chevrolet app,
whoa,
all you have to do is download it.
I have it.
There you go.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Now, I like this.
Yes.
This is really cool. Now, these are aftermarket, correct?
Yes.
I like that. That looks really, really cool.
And it shows you the running light, the left turn, right turn, brake lights, and reverse lights.
I like that.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Wow. And what is this right here for?
So that's where you would plug in your boat. This is the socket for your boat.
Oh, yeah, yeah. For towing your boat trailers and stuff.
Right. And your multi-face tailgate.
I like that. I see that a lot, which is really cool. Because it can fold in different ways, which is really cool. Check this out. Whoa! That is cool. And see, this can fold down, make like a little staircase. Makes it easy to get in. Now that is cool.
Speakers
in the tailgate. Wow. I'd like to see Ford try and do something like this. I don't think they ever would.
That's right.
Because, hey, I'm in a group called Ford Sucks, Get a Chevy. Right?
There you go.
Yeah, and you guys are doing it right. Thank you for keeping the internal combustion engine alive, especially the V8 alive, into, you know, when everyone else is pooping out electric pieces of junk that nobody wants. Because we love gas and diesel, and we can't live without it. Keep at it.
No comment.
What do you mean? We still need more gas and diesel. We need it. And we want it.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. And what's your name?
Yolanda.
Steven.
Nice to meet you.
You too. Thanks for showing me. This is pretty neat.
No problem.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah. And here's another pontoon. This one's a Suzuki engine here. 300. It's a Vanderbilt 27T. Whoa, MSRP 250 grand. It's got two engines, making a total of 600 horsepower in this monster. Wow. Look at that. 600 horsepower in this pontoon boat. And look at this. The side lights up, which is really neat. So I'm going to climb inside here now. Whoa, it's a long buoy. It's huge. Wow, look at this. It's got LED lighting that lights up the interior accents. That's really neat looking. And it's got a little desk here if you want to grab a bite to eat on the water. Little canopy roof right up there. And here's the driver's seat with the digital instrument cluster computer screens. That looks really cool. Another screen right over here. I know, it's a monster. Look at this. It's got 600 horsepower, two engines. It's insane. I know. Look at that. And look, there's LED lights all around. Like, see all these lights? They light up. It's insane.
Oh, bro, no.
Yeah. Look at that. Yeah, it's all right. Hey, start them young. That's parenting done right. Yeah. Wow. That looks beautiful. And there's two extra little desk little areas right here. So here's a desk on this side and a desk on that side, complete with four cup holders each, eight cup holders in total, which are beside the two engines. How about that? This is a pretty interesting looking party boat, if you ask me. So over there is a Sailfish, also powered by Suzuki. Sailfish, so those are like fishing boats. Let's see what these are. So here's one of the Sailfish boats. Suzuki engine as well, 200 horsepower. Climb up inside here. These little kids want to get in the view as well. So looks like they want to join in on the fun. So here's more seating right here. And here's some cup holders on this side. Basic driver seat panel here. There's a tiny screen, but not much in here. I mean, I think this is a Garmin screen, but I think it's covered. I don't know for sure. I think it's probably covered. And there's your, I think this is a gyro compass. I think that's what it is. I used to have that in one of my boats in my lake house a long time ago. And here is the bow or the front right here with all this bench seating. There's more pontoon boats on that side right over here. And right over there is StarCraft boats, StarCraft Marine. Those are powered by Yamaha engines as well. What a great view of this. This is insane. Oh, that's cool. That opens up right there. Wow. Oh, that's cool.
For the anchor.
Oh, for an anchor. Okay, that's pretty neat. Wow. That one's like a fishing boat. You could probably tell because of the central driving position. Let's get inside here. 241cc. Mercury power. Oh, yeah. Mercury Marine. Corrado. That's pretty neat. Let's get inside here. So here's the central driving position with this boat. Look at that giant screen in the front. That's insane. Wow. And here's the canopy roof right up front, right at the top. Wow. And this is the GPS from Garmin. That is massive. That's crazy. You can stow all your fishing gear on here. Here's that big comfy driving bench seat, which is insane and comfy. And here's like a little stool, I think, that folds out. I don't know what this thing is. Probably a, I don't know, maybe a flap or something. Here's an extra bench right here at the top of the bow. Cup holders as well. Put your fishing gear stuff on here as well. There's even a bench right in front of the driver's console. That's pretty cool. Wow. Trying to get better views of this because last time some people complained that my footage was a little bit low, meaning, you know, my camera was pointed a little bit lower. So I'm trying to improve on it this time and point it a little bit higher so I can provide a better view. But what you got to understand and realize is sometimes when you're walking around in places like this, you got to be very careful. You got to watch where you're going, and you got to make sure that you don't run into people or trip over stuff or fall or whatever. You don't want that. So you got to be careful when doing this. So that's what I'm working on. Let's see what this one. Here's another pontoon. It's also called a Bentley. So that's different than the Bentley British car. Bentley is also an American pontoon boat. How about that? It's got various options on it too. Suzuki engine, 300. 300 horsepower Suzuki engine. It's a 300 horsepower V6, 4-stroke. Drive-by-wire.
Wow.
And that's one of the sales reps. Wow. I'm going to go ahead and get on top of this, see what this is like. So here's the roll bar here. This bar prevents you from escaping into the water at high speed, so that's always good. Here's the canopy roof at the top. Big bench seat right there. Swivel passenger seat and then swivel driver seat. Two Simrad computer screens right here. That looks really cool. Got the radio going on that one. Door is open there. There's another Bentley pontoon right over there. That one's called the Bolt. Also Suzuki power. And this one next to us is Suzuki powered as well. Oh yeah, and it's got also LED lights in the cup holders. Now that is really cool. Just like in some of these.
It's going to be the same width and they're
going to
be the same
thing. Oh wow. So this is a different Bentley than the British car, huh?
Yes, it's not the automaker and the boat are totally different.
I know, because that'll confuse a lot of people, I bet, does it? Do you get a lot of comments from those kinds of people or what?
Not often. I've joked around about it before, but
oh, yeah?
It's everybody pretty much knows that they're the same.
Well, my mom has a Bentley car, so.
Okay, yeah. Yes, the Bentley boat and the Bentley car, two totally different manufacturers.
Yeah, they're completely different animals, that's for sure.
Yes, sir.
And now, what is this over here on this side?
What's that?
This right here.
This is a fold-out table.
Oh, wow. Oh, it's like a little mini desk.
Yes.
With so little cup holders on there.
And used to a common option there was a changing room.
Oh wow.
And it would come up, but it would have like a little square curtain in it. That's still an option. But
that's cool.
This has became a better option.
Okay. Okay. And I like the two Simrad computer screens right here at the driver's seat here. That looks really, really cool.
Yes. Wow.
And that looks very ergonomic as well.
Oh, yeah. And that's that right over there is a cordless phone charger. You can set your phone down there.
I do like that. That's really cool.
Wow. Yes, ma'am.
Ron, what's the difference between this version and the 2023 version?
There's probably one thing is probably going to be your cell phone holder there.
Wow. This is pretty neat looking. But I feel like there's a lot more boats I need to see. There's a lot of boats here. There's definitely a lot more boats here than cars. That's for sure. So there's more Bentley boats. They're pretty much all similar. These are all different accessories they can add in the Bentley boats. These are LED speakers. These are really cool. Different radio controls. Garmin GPS. It's pretty cool looking. And there's Bayliner right over here. These are Mercury power. Ooh, 26 grand. That's pretty affordable. 75 horsepower. Wow. Okay, Mercury outboard. Let's get inside this. Bayliner M17. Let's see, get up on top of here. Oh wow, look at this. So there's cup holders on both sides here. You get a little small seat on the rear and another small seat next to it. And right here, this little pole stack, I think you could put an umbrella right there. But there's also a canopy roof on top of here as well. And there's another bench seat right here at the rear. Also where the driver's seat is. Let's see if I can crawl inside here a little bit. Pretty basic driver's seat console. Got your speedometer and your RPM and stuff right there. No screens or computers on this one. All basic and simple. And you get little small seating right here in the front as well. It's a smaller boat, so smaller boats are typically going to cost a lot less than your big monster boat. So there's that. Another Bayliner. That one's like a fishing boat. Trophy T22. Yeah, it's got the central driving position with the canopy roof on top. Mercury 150. That's a good one, that Mercury 150. Yeah.
Okay.
Navigating this could get a little challenging at certain times. Just got to be very careful though. Okay. This one's about 40 grand here. Here's the VR4. Similar cruiser type. Heyday. Oh, so this one's a Heyday. Ooh, 6.2 liter Mercruiser V8. Could be similar to Chevrolet, like the LS. Wow, this is pretty cool. Heyday. Never seen that before. Look at that. That's 70 grand. That could be a wee bit. Same with 89 grand. Yeah, that could be a wee bit too, but still. With a monster engine like that, the 6.2, you gotta love that. This one's 320 horsepower. Heyday H20. Never heard of Heyday before. Got some pretty neat stuff. Go ahead and climb up inside here. Wow, look at this. Wow. Canopy roof on top, complete with an LED spotlight. It's kind of neat. Same with that one as well. It's got a lot of bench seating on it and a lot of cup holders. Same with this one too. Go ahead and climb inside here.
Excuse me.
And here's an extra cubby inside where the steering wheel is. A little computer screen.
This is the driver.
Yeah, it is the driver's seat. You like that, huh? Start them young. That's parenting done right. Yep.
This is a storm.
You like that,
it's
huh?
A storm in the middle of a city.
Yeah.
We have to hide right now because it's about to hit us.
You want a boat?
Called it as a rock.
Yeah.
Let's do it, bud.
I think he's going to be a boat owner in the future. What do you think?
Yeah, he definitely will be.
Oh, yeah. I don't blame him. Yeah. This is just what the next generation of boating needs right now. And you're raising them right. Yeah. And right up here, we have more bench seating right up here. A lot of bench seating on this one. A lot of cup holders.
Sit on the back.
More bench seating here. And this is where you can attach surfboards and knee boards. This little claw thing here can tie those down, prevent those from moving if you're towing them. Bentley boats.
Nobody's jumping in the water.
And these look like more fishing boats over here. Let's see what these are. There's a Yamaha Power SH. I think that's what this is. Little giant staircase. That's funny. Get inside here. Oh, wow. Quite a bit of a step right there. Got to be careful. And, wow. Garmin GPS. Central driving position. Hence why it's basically a fishing boat. Big giant bench right here. Comfy bench seating right up here. And another bench right here. Right up here is where you can put your fishing gear. And maybe your trolling motor and stuff. There's some marine boat service supplies desk right over there. Let's see. I think that one's got a compartment on that side. I wonder what this one has. Oh yeah, this does have a little door compartment. Let's see if maybe if I can open this up and see what it does. Let's see. Can I open? Oh yeah, you can open this up and look at this. So I think this is more like an empty storage room area here. I wonder if maybe if you can install a bathroom toilet in here as well. I think some of these boats have that as an option. I may be wrong, but I think so. But yeah, that gives you a pretty good option there. There's a Yamaha engine right there on the side. And this one is Pioneer. Twin engine monster. Powered by two Suzuki engines. Whoa! 265 grand has cost. Now 200 grand because of this discount by Advantage, which is still quite a wee bit, so yeah. Suzuki 250 four strokes. It's probably V6s, I think. Measuring ruler right there. That's where the engines are, right there. Also with a central driving position as well. With multiple screens, I think about three of them, all from Garmin. Big bench right here for two people, which is cool, both the driver and passenger here. Same with that one over there. And there's another fishing boat right over here, an actual fishing boat. I'll check that one out in a moment. Here's a compartment in here, but if you look close, if you look really, really close down there, you can see it has a toilet on board, which is really cool. So if you need to go to the bathroom, use this. When you're out in the water, this is perfect. So when you gotta go, you gotta go. This makes it really easy to do so. I really like that feature. Makes it very practical. And there's more seats right up here. Bench seats. As well as another bench seat in front of the driver's console. This one's really cool, actually. Another Pioneer next to it. These are all Pioneers. Now, let's look at this actual fishing boat. It's got a Mini Kota trolling motor on it. Here's a swivel chair on the front. Different cupboards where you can put your fish after you catch them. This is from Express Boats. It's got a GPS computer right in front of the driver's console. A rear swivel chair. It's from Express. Yamaha V-Max engine. 115 horsepower. Express H20. That's what it's called. And this is an extra seat right here on this side. Another fishing boat over here, Express. And wow, look at this one. This one is called Avenger. And it's got the beautiful American flag on the side. Hell yeah, brother. Gotta love that. Central driving position right here. With two giant screens right there from Garmin. Also a fishing boat. It's got a Garmin trolling motor on the side as well. Which is really neat. And over here.
Simple. You know, it's what goes with everything.
This is Tohatsu McCurry's Outboard Repairs. So these are Tohatsu engines. Never heard of these before. These look pretty new. Wow. I've never seen these before.
Tohatsu?
No, never seen Tohatsu before. I've heard of Komatsu, but not Tohatsu.
Tohatsu.
Ah.
Been manufacturing motors for 68 years.
68 years? Wow.
Commercial outboard motor builder. The company itself is 100 years old.
Wow.
I've been selling for 32 years.
Oh, congratulations. Wow. And let's see, which one is this right over here?
That's
the 90. Wow. Is this a V8 or... Or V6 or four-cylinder or what?
Four-cylinder.
Okay. How many cubic inches or liters? Could be maybe like a 2 liter or something maybe. I may be wrong. I doubt that, but could be around there. And how much horsepower does this one make? 90 horsepower. Okay. So it could be about like maybe a 2 liter or something a little less maybe. So yeah, this... gives you an idea of what all the inner workings of this looks like and how you can work on it in case if you need repairs done. That's really neat. And what's your name, sir?
Oscar McCurry.
Steven.
Are you with somebody?
No, sir. I'm just here on my own.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah. And this is a puny tiny one. Wow, this one's really tiny. I wonder what this one is.
That's a 30 horse.
Oh, 30 horsepower. How many cylinders?
Three-cylinder,
okay. Okay, wow. Weighs 161 pounds, okay, wow. And look at this big buoy over here. Let's see what this one is. Tohatsu. Weighs over 400 pounds. 140. This means it's got 140 horsepower. Never heard of Tohatsu before. And these are... more accessories over here, as well as decorative items and stuff that you could buy. A lot of different stuff here. Oh, that's a pretty looking little board. But you could actually put a motor on this too. What is this? It's got a little motor on it. Is this like a motorized surfboard or something, or what is this?
It's a paddleboard that can be turned into a micro skiff, yeah.
A micro skiff, so that's what you call it, a micro skiff?
Yeah.
So you steer it by this lever here, correct? And then, you know, you twist it like a motorcycle, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
Oh, like the old school way of operating motorboats. Oh, wow. And what kind of engine is this?
That's a 5 horsepower Tohatsu.
And how many cylinders? Oh, it's a single cylinder. Okay. Four stroke or two stroke?
Four.
Oh, four stroke. Wow. And how fast does this go?
15 to 20.
Wow. This probably weighs nothing. What's the weight on this? Oh, yeah. 65 pounds. Look at that. I mean, for something like this, yeah, that's pretty light. That's pretty neat. I mean, wow, a giant surfboard with a motor on it. Who would have thought of that? Was this your idea?
Yep, I worked with them, Live Large.
So you decided to put an engine on this. This is your idea, your baby,
about 5
right?
5 years in the work, yeah.
Wow. How about this? And what's your name?
Austin.
Steven. Dude, nice to meet you. Wow. So Austin is the maker of this motorized surfboard. This is his baby. So if you want to motorize your surfboard or wakeboard or whatever, talk to Austin. He'll motorize it for you.
Ain't that right, my dude?
That is crazy. Wow, I wish there were more motorized surfboards out there. Because, hey, wind and wave power ain't enough sometimes, right? Wind or wave power ain't enough sometimes. Yeah, you need that extra oomph. You need that. Exactly. You're a super genius. I mean, this looks like something that could have been made about 20, 30 years ago, right? Wow. And you made it. This is your baby. Wow. Congratulations. I hope these sell like hotcakes. Keep it up. Wow, that is cool. Wow. A motorized surfboard. How fun is this? Made by Austin. And here's some comfy beds over here. Some dock lines for tying up your boat. Ah, temple tents. Those are neat. Oh, wow. Never seen these before. These are pretty neat.
Well, I think so. My wife got tired of putting her feet on the cooler. You
know? Oh, yeah?
Because everybody kept getting into the cooler.
Right? So, did you make this or what?
Yeah.
How did you do that?
Well, we've got a sewing plant in South Georgia, we've been in business for 35 years.
Wow.
My wife ordered some foam. She ordered some fabric.
Sweet.
Got an embroidery machine.
Yeah?
And she went to work.
I like that.
Got them in three sizes.
Wow.
Small, medium, large.
That's cool.
And then we also do bags and totes and stuff like that.
Okay. So, hey, are you?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, but we came last year. Nobody had anything like it. They said, okay.
So wow. Well, that's great. You know, I love, you know, I love people like you guys in our country making stuff that nobody else has. I mean, that's awesome. That's innovation right there.
Yeah.
And what's your name, sir?
Bobby Blaine.
Steven.
Steven, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Oh, thank you. Let's see what this is. Wow, look at that. That's cool. There's all their information on this, too. Wow, thank you. Thank you. Oh, look at this.
How are you?
Hole cleaning. Good, sir. How are you?
Doing
and
good.
What is this?
That is when we use the screen to scrub
the bottom of holes. Wow. A hole scrubber, huh? It almost looks like a buffer tool or something like that. Because I use one of these working on cars sometimes as well.
All right. This one's fully submersible to go underwater, though.
Wow.
Battery operated.
So how does it work without electrocuting yourself? Because water and electricity doesn't mix. That can cause some deadly shocks that could injure or kill you.
It could, but this has O-ring seals on it so that it doesn't like anybody.
Oh, that's good. Always about those O-ring seals, you know, because those are very good. You got to love those O-ring seals. That'll help you from anything. Wow. So that takes all these barnacles and stuff off, right?
Wow. On freshwater, it's algae, not barnacles. So, yes.
Oh, not barnacles. Okay, I was going to say, yeah, because those must be pretty hard to take off, huh? Wow. That's pretty neat. I've never seen these before. Wow. I like these. And what's your name, sir?
My name's Vic.
Steven.
Pleasure.
You too, sir. Wow, this is pretty neat. Thanks for showing me, sir. Wow, look at these. And there's T-Mobile. There's a lot of other booths around here. There's a lot of stuff that I haven't even seen yet. Even more boats that I haven't yet seen. But yet, it's over an hour now. Man. I have no idea how much stuff is here, but I can tell there's already a lot more stuff here than at the auto show. That is for sure. And there's more stuff down here. TechSmart. Phone chargers. You gotta love that. And here are some desks right over here. That looks really neat. Paradise grills. I like that. Oh, here's a little tiny pontoon boat for $6,000. Wow, that's dirt cheap. Wow, look at that. Aqua cycle. So it's a pedal boat. Wow, how about that? This has got to be the biggest pedal boat I've ever seen. That's crazy. Wow. And you could sit on it and eat on it too. Wow. Aqua cycle. That's pretty fun. I like that.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, sir. How are you? Is this yours?
Yes. Yourself.
Did you make it?
I mean, I built it.
You built it yourself? Dude, that's so cool. Wow. How did you do that? Did you get, like, random parts of various boats and put it all together, or even bicycle pedals and put it all together, or how'd you do that?
I didn't invent it. I put these together.
Wow. Home built, not bought. I love that. You know, that's exactly what we need these days, because, you know, building your own vehicle or whatever is a dying breed these days, because we need more DIYers. We really do. And what's your name, sir?
Is this going on YouTube?
Yes, sir. It is going on YouTube.
I prefer that I'm not being able to.
Oh, sorry, sir. My bad.
But if you want, you reshoot the video and I just get out of the shot.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's fine. Thank you, sir. Yeah, thanks for showing me. I appreciate that. Wow, that dude built this own boat. That's really cool. Here's some golf carts. They're electric golf carts. At least they're much better than other electric cars, that's for sure.
It's one of the highest quality lithium batteries on the market now.
Oh, you are.
Here's some more pontoons over here, and whoa! Look at this monster. What is this? It's a four-seater power boat.
Interesting. I don't know how much it is.
Honda Power. Let's see what this is.
I think it's a little bit deeper than I thought, to be honest with you. I think so, too.
Accelerator 151 mini power boat. 15 and a half feet long. 35 feet high. Weighs 440 pounds. It's got a 75-horsepower Honda engine. Look at this. All basic and simple. No frills here. No luxuries. This is all for racing. Except with two extra seats. Wow. I love power boats. They are really fun. Is this yours?
Yes, it is.
I love it. I'm a huge fan of these power boats. They're fun.
Yeah.
All right.
Wow. All right, what was your name?
I'm Bill. All
right, Bill. Y'all are from?
I'm from Buford.
Buford.
Sweet.
We're close by. Right.
Yeah, Chris. Right.
Yes, sir. And is this like an entry-level power boat, or what other engine options or other stuff do you have for this?
Well, there's a ladder that goes on the side right here.
Oh, yeah?
It just clips on the side over there.
Sweet.
Okay. Seats fold down. They move forward and back.
Yeah?
So
wow. It's got cup holders in there as well. You got to have cup holders.
Yep.
Wow.
Can't move here real well, but that shows you got lots of leg space.
Oh, okay.
That seat swivels around so you can face backwards and watch the skiers.
That's cool. And I'm a huge fan of power boats, especially when they put monster Chevrolet big block supercharged V8s on them. And they do like over 200 miles an hour with them. Those ones are monsters. Those are insane. I love those. Well, and this design looks very similar.
This boat's just a small version of that.
Ah, wow.
When you're on the water, 40 miles an hour that this boat will do feels like 80.
Right? I mean, it's insane.
Such a small boat.
Wow.
15-6 long.
Wow.
Boat weighs 440.
Wow.
Boat weighs nothing.
That's insane. I love these boats. They're just fun, you know? Because boating's not just about luxury. You want speed and power. That's all you need.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's difficult
to
work with. So, fun little sport boat.
Wow. I love this. This is cool. And now, can you put other engines on this if you so desire,
yeah,
or
you
what?
You can go lower or you can go higher. We don't recommend it. Coast Guard let us put a 75 on here, but
ooh.
I don't recommend it because it's... We have to put trim tabs to try to keep the chine walking down. It's just too much torque for this little boat.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. Wow.
But customers do what they want, and I've got customers that'll buy the boat without a motor and hang a 150 on it.
Wow.
And, of course, that's their own neck that they're risking.
Sweet. And, hey, about $21,000. You know, that's a pretty good price.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, that's pretty good. And
they're built to order. Online,
let's see.
Directboats.com.
Directboats.com. So that's your group, that's your company?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
You go to mini power boats.
Whoa, dude.
You just pick out whichever one you want. That's this one.
Oh, that's cool.
Or that it's actually this one.
Oh, okay.
Package.
Wow.
So it starts at $96.49 for just the bare boat.
Oh, wow.
Just add what options you want.
Now that's cool. I'm a fan.
We have two seaters. We have mini tugboats.
Mini tugs.
We have tons and tons of boats on our website. We're basically ship factory direct.
Sweet. I'm a fan of that. I really am. And where are you guys located?
Out of America's Georgia.
Sweet. Wow. I'm in Atlanta, so hopefully not too far.
Yeah.
Wow. And I wonder, do you have any airboats? Because that's what I want. I want a diesel-powered airboat.
I do not have a diesel-powered airboat, but I do have a lot of different boat choices up here.
Oh, wow.
So, if you color all categories, you'll see. We have small pontoons, mini powerboats, skiffs.
Wow.
John boats, bass boats.
Oh, that's cool.
Inflatables, rowboats, metal boats.
Whoa, you got everything.
Kayaks, canoes, theme park boats.
Theme park boats?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Gondolas.
Oh, wow, that's funny.
Pedal boats, travels.
Wow, you make everything.
Yep.
I feel like Georgia's the boat capital of the whole country, right?
Maybe.
I think so. Yeah, with you guys in charge, there's no doubt about that. Wow. But yeah, I just had to see this because I'm a huge fan of these V-drive power boats. They're just fun. And they just look good. And they're so customizable, which I love about that.
Yep, you can order it whatever color you want.
Oh, yeah. And what's your name, sir?
Roger.
Steven.
Nice to meet you, Steven.
Nice to meet you too, dude. I love this monster. This is amazing. Keep making more of these. Please do. I love it. Oh, yeah, brother. Ah, here's another fishing boat from B&B Marine and Conyers. It's got multiple swivel chairs and a trolling motor at the front. Here's some more stuff down here. More displays. Oh, look at that. There's a little hammock or a swing set. It's like a hammock swing. SoCo swings. That's funny. And here's another pontoon. It's called the Paradigm. Whoa, $150,000 for this monster. Wow. Canopy roll bar and roof on the top. Let's go up inside here. Okay. Oh, wow. Look at this. It has a grill right here. So it's got a little mirror right here for your grill. It has a sink right here as well. And there's valve armor right there. Those are little boat anchors for your trailer, I think. But wow, a boat with a grill on board, that's insane. Also, you get another bench seat with a cup holder desk. Suzuki 350 engine right back here, 350 horsepower. Got their display screen right there, Paradigm Boats. There's one of their other ones right next to us in that blue. That looks pretty cool. Garmin GPS screen right here. And more bench seating here. Door to get in and out of. I wonder what that one is right there on that side. Let's see. Another Paradigm. This one's a little bit higher off the ground. This one's called the 2965 UAF. Wait, UAF or URF? Oh, it's U... Oh, excuse me, SURF. I'm sorry. It's 296 SURF. I read that completely wrong. 296 SURF, so that's what this is. And here's the specs on it. Volvo Penta engine, 430 horsepower. Whoa, it weighs 7,200 pounds. That's insane. But I completely butchered the name. It says SURF. Sorry, the logo kind of gives it away a little bit. That's crazy. But yeah, that paint job looks really cool. I like that blue color. Excuse me. And here's the inside of this monster. Let's have a look. Swivel seat right here.
How you doing?
Good, sir. How are you?
Good.
Is this yours?
Yes, sir.
Whoa, what a monster. I love it.
Yeah.
Wow. Got the screens here. I like that. Paradigm Damascus. Wow. And what's underneath here? That's under the floor. Oh, storage?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Wow, look at that. That's cool. Basically, and what's in here, like right in there?
Yeah, it's just storage.
More storage?
Yeah.
Okay. And I really like how this has a grill and a sink right here. Now, that is just cool. Because, hey, if you want to have a cookout out on the water, why not? I mean, did you make this or did you think of this or what?
Yeah, we designed it.
You designed it?
Yep.
How did you do it?
30 years of being in the boat business and listening to people.
Wow. Well, I can tell you did a great job. I mean, this is cool. Grilling out on the lake, huh?
Yeah.
Doesn't get any better than that. Wow. That is neat. You should keep doing that. That's really neat. Yeah. I like that. Yeah, grilling some burgers and hot dogs out at sea? Why not?
Yeah.
That looks fun.
Go for a day of surfing and go back to the boat and go some burgers.
Yeah, brother. That's right. And what's your name, sir?
Scott.
Steven.
Yeah. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, you too. I love these monsters.
Thank you.
Thanks for showing me around.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some more pontoons over here. Power and performance sales event from Yamaha Outboards. These ones are all Yamaha. Oh, wow. I wonder what's up here. So the ladder's out here so I can get in here. It's got a huge LED light here. It's really, really bright. Let's see. It's called the Sun Chaser. You can tell because this logo on the steering wheel. Simrad computer screen right there. And this is open. This looks like a little changing area for changing your bathing suit and stuff. That's kind of neat. Here's another deck right here that you can walk on to get in and out of these boats easier. Yeah, this is Sun Chaser, also a pontoon boat. Yeah, these are all Sun Chaser pontoon boats. Got some LEDs in there too. These are more Avalon boats over here. And here's a display screen of the Garmin radio head unit screens and speakers. Those are cool. Oh, look at this monster. This Avalon. It's got a Suzuki right over here. 250. This one's the Platinum Edition. Whoa, there's a lot of room up there. Let's see, is there a step stool to get in? Oh, there is. Yeah, there is. I'm gonna go ahead and climb up here now. Wow. This one's a long buoy. It's got LEDs on the speakers. Very similar to some of the other pontoons I saw. But yeah, that Avalon's really cool. All right, over here. I like these puzzle pieces on the floor. That looks really cool. Plus it cushions your footsteps so that you'll have less impact on the ground. More pontoon boats. See, there's more grass shack. And there is a Key West boat over here, kind of like a fishing boat or something. Key West, Suzuki engine power, 150. Staircase here. A lot of cupboards and cup holders and the center console for the driver and passenger in there. And there is a little extra dummy seat at the very front on that one next to us, which is pretty neat. Same with that one. That actually comes upward like that. Hence why it could possibly be a fishing boat.
No, man, I appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah, I still think about it.
And wow, this one's got LEDs lighting up all around. Look at this monster. another Avalon pontoon boat, and there's a diagram of one of the Suzuki engines, 150, 175, and 115 through 140 horsepower, respectively. This one's a 2-liter four-cylinder. Whereas this one is called a big block inline four. It's probably a little over maybe 3 liters or something like that. I don't know. But yeah, definitely a lot bigger than that. That's for sure. And I'm going to go ahead and get inside this one here. Whoa, look at this one. This one's huge. And I like that red one right there next to us as well. Wow.
Has your wireless chargers.
Wireless chargers? Wow. Oh, okay. Wow. LED cup holders too.
The sound system here too.
Whoa! Big canopy roof right up here. Oh yeah. I like the computer screens here and the driver console layout. That looks really neat.
Yeah, that's nice.
Oh yeah, that is beautiful. Wow. That red one looks good too. Pardon me. Huh, looks like there's a horn going off somewhere. I wonder what horn that is or where it's coming from. Huh. Looks like someone's playing with that horn pretty crazy, huh? And look at these yachts. I'm guessing these are like mini yachts or something over here. Not as big as the full-size yachts, but they're still pretty big. So you can literally climb up on top of them, get inside them. This one's called Blue Water. Looks like a monster fishing boat. Twin Suzuki engines. 600 horsepower, which is insane, whereas this one's got 400 horsepower. Whoa, this one's huge. Multiple underfloor storage units. Bench seating here. Oh, that screen looks a little bit messed up there. In central driving position. I'm sure it's got a horn somewhere.
I see it.
It's got to be on there somewhere.
We don't see no horns.
I wonder if you could put an air horn on there, like from a train. That'd be cool. That'd be better. Mm-hmm. That's what I'd want.
Underwater lights.
Oh, yeah, underwater lights. Now that's cool. Wow. And there's a lot of cup holders and stuff on the side there. Oh, and there's extra cup holders here, right at the rear. That's interesting. Speakers here on the side. And what is down here? Is that extra storage down there or what?
It's like a fish box.
Oh, wow. You could fit like a shark in there if you caught one, right? That'd be
interesting.
Yes, I am.
What's your YouTube name?
Mr. Chevrolet 94.
Mr. Chevrolet 94.
Oh, yeah.
You was right.
That's right. Yeah. Uh-huh. Thank you.
I'm on YouTube.
Yeah, that's right. You're on YouTube, my dude. That's right. Yeah. Oh, and let's look at that one over there. That's like a mini yacht. What is this over here? That's huge. What is that? Exopar, so that's what this is. What a monster. Let's see if we can get inside this. Well, sir?
Not that good. Like
Whoa. Hey, good sir, how are you? Yeah. Wow. 600 horsepower each with these two V8s? That's insane. What a monster.
Keep all the gas there, huh?
Oh, probably like under here somewhere. The fuel tank's got to be under here somewhere. probably does. Sir? Whoa. What's in here?
Well, this is storage, and this is where you put your stove.
Wow. You can have a stove here?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. And is that like a sink right there?
That's a sink. This is a refrigerator.
Dude. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, so that's a fridge, and then we do air conditioning on these boats. We do lithium 12-volt systems.
Wow. Now, is this basically a mini yacht or what? What do you classify this as?
This is an adventure sport mini yacht would be my class on this boat.
Adventure sport mini yacht. Wow, these are cool. Mind if I check out what's inside here?
Absolutely. Come on here.
Let's see. Whoa, look at this. Pump out. Oh, look at what's down here.
Oh, yes. It's cool, isn't it?
That's crazy. There's like an extra room right down there with beds. And a sofa. You can sleep in here.
Yeah.
Let's see what's in here. Wow. Look at this. There's a lot of room under here. And it's got a toilet.
Underneath there.
Wow.
TV drops down.
That's cool. Ooh.
That's for your...
drop down TV?
No.
I was going to say.
You can put one in it, but it doesn't come with one.
Oh, wow.
It comes with the stereo.
Wow, and you can sleep in there too. That can form as a bed, right?
Yeah.
That is so cool.
And
I like that.
You can also get it with the back.
And I like that little outlet for your phone chargers and stuff if you need any. Oh, wow, and it's got a toilet there. You need that, especially on the water where there's nowhere to go. When you gotta go, you gotta go, you know?
Yeah,
and what's all this stuff here? Is that a control panel or what is that?
It's just your circuit breakers and your fuses and things.
Wow. That's cool.
How do you spell your name on YouTube?
Oh, it's it's MRCHEVROLET 94. Yeah. Oh, yeah? Sure. Sure, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Tyler.
Yeah.
Come on, come in.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. And what's your name?
King. My name is King.
King. Oh, like Dr. Martin Luther King, huh?
Yes.
And what's your name?
Chandler.
Chandler? All right. Wow.
So it's MR.
Yeah, MRCHEVROLET 94. No spaces.
Take the bat off.
That's right, yeah. Uh-huh.
Say that again.
Yeah.
Say the word about
you. So King, right?
Yes.
Yeah, and Chandler.
Yes.
My two new subscribers. And so now we're outside at the top, at the bow of the deck of this mini yacht. And there are more of these paddings here. You can actually sit or sleep on here if you so desire. This is really cool. These mini yachts are really cool. And that looks like, I think, what is that? Is that a winch up there? Or is that an anchor post? Probably an anchor, I think. That's pretty crazy. Wow, what a monster this is. Wow. You gotta love these mini yachts. You don't need billions of dollars on a giant fancy yacht. You just get one of these mini yachts and you're good to go. Wow. Right? Exactly.
Nautical adventures.
Nautical adventures. All right.
That's
all right. And oh, look at this. It's a water bike. Schiller. Look at that. Little pedals on there, which control a rudder right here at the rear. That's pretty neat. And you can drive it on the water like that. How's that for a water bike? It's pretty neat. Oh, that's pretty cool. Is that like another deck or something? Exopar. I wonder what this thing is. Looks like maybe motorized or something. What is this thing? Sir, what exactly is this right here? What is this thing?
It's an underwater submarine type thing.
Whoa. So can you ride it or how does it work? I'm guessing you drive it by using these handlebars and stuff. Wow. Oh, that's cool. It's like a little mini jet ski, I think. I think that's what it is. That's pretty neat. It's called the Sea Bob from Exopar. Same maker of this Monster Mini Yacht. Monster Mini Yacht. Yeah, because that's exactly what it is. It's a mini yacht. Which is crazy. Yeah. Thank you all. See you later. Yeah. My two new future subscribers. This is crazy. Oh, look at this. Aquabanas. So that's like a little small tent that can double as a float on the water. That's really cool. You can actually sit on there. You can maybe eat your food in there. Do all kinds of things on there. It's pretty neat. Here's Marine Max over here with their booth. They got a disco ball over there. Got a party going on here? What's going on?
Welcome to Marine Max.
Okay. Got more boats over here. Let's see what these are. Wow. Aviara, I think that's what this is. Wow. It's pretty looking. Oh, that's really neat looking. Got a huge canopy roof on the top of this one. Wow. A lot of bench seating on this one. Looks like you got to take your shoes off if you want to go inside here. And this Avaria. Excuse me, or Aviara. I think that's how it's pronounced. And look at this. It also has another stove on it. Wow, look at this. Wow. It also has a stove on this one, too. Look at this. That stove is really cool for grilling burgers and hot dogs and steak out on the lake or the river or wherever you're at on the water. You gotta love that. Here's an extra little storage thing here. Could maybe double as a sink. Here's the driver's seat here with a giant computer screen by Simrad, GPS. And this is your diagnostics computer right here. Also doubles as your radio. All kinds of stuff here. And here's up here, bench seating up here. It's pretty big. I like that. Wow. You gotta love these boats and how customizable they are. They're insane. And let's see what this is. There's a DJ booth and the disco spotlight going off right there. And here's the Sea Ray. I like the diamond plate staircase right there. The diamond plate looks really cool. That's a Sea Ray SPX 210. Canopy roof on the top. And here's a Simrad computer screen right here. Seat here.
Yeah.
Little compartment right here. And a bench right up here at the front bow. That looks really neat. And this one's slightly bigger. Also a Sea Ray. SDX 270 Surf. Also with a canopy roof on it, and it's got surfboards on it too. Hence why it's called Surf. Wow. These Sea Rays are really cool. It's a compartment right in here. And look at that. It's got a bathroom inside here, complete with a toilet and a sink. Check that out. So, whenever you gotta go, you gotta go. I mean, this is very practical. Yeah, how about that? Because if you need to go to the bathroom, then you go right in there. Easy.
How do we get down there?
You just open this door, and then there's a little staircase right there. Yeah, you can see it? Like that. Simrad computer screen right there and GPS. Yeah, there you go. Easy to get in and out of. I really like that. I wish more boats had that. Very useful feature.
Some boats have some decks.
Yeah, they do. Oh, and there's another radio screen unit right there on that side. And look at this monster right over here. Let's see what this is. Wow. This also could be a mini yacht right over here. Looks like we've got to take our shoes off again for this. 500 grand, whoa. This one's called the Sundancer 320, also by Sea Ray. Whoa, look at this monster. A lot of people on here, so bear with me. And it's got a stove on it. You gotta have a stove on these monster mini yachts. Wow. And there's a sink right there too. You need that. Here's the inside. There's the driver's seat.
And it pushes in. Yep.
And it looks like someone's honking the horn on one of those boats over there. And look at this. A sunroof right there. You don't really see a lot of that on a boat, let alone a mini yacht. And inside, there's a bathroom with a shower in there. Let's check this out.
A shower.
That is right. That's crazy.
Can I get out of the video?
Sorry.
You're fine.
Wow, look at this. A full-size bathroom. So you got a toilet in here, a sink, and a shower right inside this mini yacht. It's insane. And right next to it are lots of beds. Wow, that's crazy. So you get beds here, so you can sleep right under here as well. Also comes with a curtain if you don't want to be disturbed. That's pretty crazy. And there's a big bench seat right up here with a TV right in front of here. That's pretty sweet. And it looks like this is a mini fridge and a microwave right there. Wow, mini yachts are full of surprises. They really are. Forget full-size yachts, because hey, mini yachts could be the way to go. Wow, what a monster. Oh, look at this monster. It's called a Teegee, I think that's what it is. A Teegee 25ZX Ultra. I can't pronounce that, but yeah, it's kind of crazy looking. So let's get inside here. Whoa, huge canopy roof with speakers on it. Look at this, wow. I like this interior, it's got LEDs all around. Wow, beautiful. I like the driver's seat layout. That looks really cool. And that screen right there. And it looks like there's a cooler right down there too. That looks pretty neat. And the speaker right there, another screen. This probably has a Bluetooth connectivity on there maybe. And there's more bench seating right up here. But yeah, I was just inside that monster mini yacht. That was insane. Which is crazy. So here's a monster right over here. This is called Cruiser's Yachts. It's definitely a yacht, all right. It's got three Mercury engines on it. Now, as much as I want to get inside this, I'm not sure if I'm able to because there's a long line to get on this one. Plus, this guy can only allow only a few people at a time to get inside there. So, I think I'm a little late to this game here. But still, this one's a monster. Now, that is a real yacht right there. Wow, that is huge. It's probably one of the biggest boats there is here at this boat show, if I'm not mistaken. I think so. This one's ATX right here on this side. Wow. It's a monster right there. And here's another small fishing boat. This is called Carolina Skiff. Suzuki engine. Also a fishing boat. I could definitely hear somebody playing with one of their horns. There's the Key West boats again. Looks like I pretty much saw everything down here. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and head on up over there. To the other end. Wow. So many boats here. A lot more boats here than cars. And now, let's check out this Sea-Doo over here. Let's see what this is. From Mountain Motorsports. Go ahead and get inside here. This is the Sea-Doo. And there's a UTV side-by-side right over here. Get up here. Wow, look at this. All minimalistic in here. A lot of storage underneath the floor. Little deck right here. Canopy roof. And look at this. Instead of a steering wheel, you drive it with a handlebar, kind of like on a jet ski or a motorcycle. Check that out. Now that's cool. Very different. And let's see. So if you look here, this is the same throttle lever that you have on a jet ski. How about that? Maybe this is a jet propulsion type boat. I may be wrong, but wow. This is pretty interesting. And here's your brake lever here. Just like on a jet ski. Wow. That's pretty impressive. Get down from here. BRP UTV. Side by side. It's a four-seater. Can-Am. That looks beautiful. Wow.
Scary stuff.
I like these monsters. These are insane, especially with the handlebars instead of the steering wheel to drive it.
Sure.
It's insane. Was that your idea?
No, I'm in the middle of something, buddy. Oh, thank you.
Yes, sir. Wow. Oh, look at this. And these are all the different layouts that you can do on these boats, too. You can customize it to your own liking. Wow. That's cool. You can build your own boat like that. Look at that. Sea-Doo Switch lineup. Wow. So that's what that is. 16 to 19 feet on the compact. And then 18 to 21 feet on the compact again. And on the Switch Cruise, 18 to 21 feet. So the regular Switch is 16 to 19 feet, and the Switch Sport is 18 to 21 feet, whereas the Switch Cruise is also 18 and 21 feet. Wow. And it looks like the Switch Cruise, you have a little bit more options that you can tweak it out with. That's pretty insane. Wow. It's so crazy that this has handlebars instead of a steering wheel to drive it. Wow. And it looks like where these are all the Mountain Motorsports dealers are located. Wow. You drive this with a handlebar like on a jet ski, which is crazy. Instead of a steering wheel.
So far, yeah.
And see right here, this is a little bit of a netting piece right here that acts as the sides of the boat for protection. Wow. I love this monster. This is so cool.
It is pretty cool, without a doubt.
Especially the way you drive it with a handlebar instead of a steering wheel.
Right.
Was that your idea to do that?
It was not.
Oh, I was going to say.
I can take neither credit nor blame for that.
Oh. Well, I give credit to whoever made that. I mean, that looks really fun and innovative and interesting.
Yeah, it is.
And I've rode jet skis before, so this should be a piece of cake.
Yeah, it's the same concept, same everything with it.
I love that. That is really cool.
It is pretty cool.
I love it.
Yeah.
Wow. So these are Honda Marines right over here. Coach pontoons. Those are beautiful. Ooh, and here's a Seabourn fishing boat, also Honda power. Ah, Honda VTEC V8. Honda doesn't really make that many V8s though. But wow, here's the information on it. 60 degree V8, 32 valves, 302 cubic inches or 5 liters or 4,952 cubic centimeters. 350 horsepower, between 5,000 and 6,000 RPM, naturally aspirated. Wow, that's pretty crazy. Wow. Outboard engines get up to 8 years of protection. That's good for warranty purposes. There's a Premier pontoon with the water slide on it. I haven't even been down here to this section yet, so I'm going to go down here. Check out some of these Yamaha jet skis. Whoa, look at this monster. The Super Jet. So the handlebars come up like this. You could lift them up like this. So you can stand on it if you so desire. So you stand right there and you ride it standing up like that, which is really cool. Although, you gotta be really careful on this monster. Because it'll bite you if you let it. Let's see, there's information on it too. 3-cylinder engine. Wow. 12 grand for this, not bad. And here's another Yamaha jet ski over here. It's called the Jet Blaster. Also 3-cylinder in here. 12 grand. Jet skis are fun. Used to ride those all the time. Here's more jet skis over here by Yamaha. Oh, look at that. Yamaha Waverunner GPHD. She's enjoying it. You like it, huh?
Yeah, I do.
I've ridden on these before, and I tell you, they're fun.
They're fine.
They are. You should get one.
I should, yeah.
Yes.
Far away from each other. Let's go closer.
Wow, look at this.
You see it?
This is cool. I like the speaker on the side there. That's kind of cool. You can have like a little speaker. You could put that up to your phone and stuff. It's pretty neat. Yeah. Wow. I bet it's pretty comfy, huh?
It is.
Wow. Sweet. And here's the Yamaha 195S, little mini cruiser. And more jet skis over here. Similar to the other one, GP. This one's the 5 VHD. I think that's what it's called. Actually, no. It's called SVHO. Mm-hmm. I thought it was called 5, but it is actually S. Wow. Wow. And these are more of Yamaha's bigger boats. This is the 222 XD. Let's see if we can get up here. Wow, it's got a canopy roof on it. Same with this one over here. It's got little clippers to attach your surfboards. And a giant computer screen right here where the driver's seat is. And look at this. Paddle shifters. Like in a race car. How about that? So this probably has a paddle shift transmission that you can shift gears manually with. Now that's cool. Never seen that on a boat before. Wow. If you're a performance car enthusiast, myself included, I think you'll love this setup here. This is very rare. Never seen that on a boat before. And of course, you got a wireless phone charger as well. Some compartments right there. More here as well. Benches right up here. Same with that one. Oh, is that storage underneath there? What's underneath there? Maybe a sink? I don't know. Huh. Let's see. It's like you can open this up here. And look at this. Probably some extra storage. And there's a ladder right in there that folds in and out. Now that's cool. That's always fun to look at. Wow. These jet skis and all these boats are really cool. More Yamaha jet skis over here. And this one has a back seat facing rear. Never saw that on a Yamaha jet ski before. Wow. That's interesting. Wow. That's cool. Wow. Look at that. And there's more up here. Here's the 195S. That looks pretty cool. Oh, here's a Yamaha fishing boat. 222 FSH Sport. Wow, look at these. Got central driver seats. Platforms to sit around on. Wow, two screens right there from Simrad. It's really neat. Got a little extra storage compartment right there. Wow, look at these. More jet skis right over there. Yamaha makes really good marine stuff. Aside from their motorcycles and outdoor power sports, their marine stuff is really cool. Oh yes, this brings me back to the good old days at my lake house. Yep, with all these jet skis. Gotta love them. Wow. There's the VX Cruiser and the FX. I have the FX Cruiser. That was a good one, but this one's brand new. I like its computer screen right there. That's pretty neat. Here's the Wave Runner, the EX. That looks really sweet. The VX. There's more Yamaha boats right here. It shows you the different models that they have. Wake series, 27 footers and 25 footers and 22 footers and 19 footers. Wow, sweet. It's pretty neat looking. Here's the 275 SD. A lot of Yamaha boats over here. And here's another compartment over here with a cup holder. Huge screen. Paddle shifters on the steering wheel. You gotta love that. Wow. Front seating right there. And on top, there's a huge canopy roof. A lot of these have canopy roofs on them. And this one's called Crown Line. Wow, that looks pretty deep looking. Here's information on it. This one's called the E285. Mercury Mercruiser 6.2 MPI. Sweet. It's got a monster V8 right there. And it's got a stove on it. And a sink. It's got two Garmin GPS computers. Extra compartments around here. Wow, look at these. Wow. These boats have stoves on them. They're insane. Wait, I don't date anymore. I just foster women until they find their forever homes. Ah, yeah, brother. Another Crown Line. Got the canopy roofs right there on the top. That almost looks like a roll cage a little bit. That was pretty neat. And more Chaparral. Chaparral's got a lot of stuff. And more Crown Lines. And Yamahas. There's pontoon boats over here. Also Yamaha.
Oh my God, that's a lot of money.
I know, it is, it's crazy. Whoa, this one's got a bathroom inside this one, the E255 from Crown Line. Wow, that's pretty neat. I like the red on there. Another Yamaha jet ski. Some of their inventories there. There is so much to see at these boat shows. Literally, it's insane. Definitely a lot more boats here than cars. See what's over here. Whoa, look at this monster. Ski Nautic, or Ski Nautique. That's what it's called. Wow, look at that. There's a huge console in the middle. I'm not sure what that's for, maybe storage. It's got a huge screen where the driver's seat is. Big seating right there. That looks really neat. This looks like a surf shop over here. That looks pretty neat. There's Nautique. There's some information on it. 355 horsepower, 405 torque. Nautique. Got some surfboard holders on the canopy roof. Wow, that looks really cool. I like how this interior looks. It also has a dial indicator right there on the side of the throttle. That's cool. Ooh, button functions such as push button start and stop. That's cool. GS22, similar one to this. And this one's the GS20. 4,700 pounds. Wow, that's pretty heavy. Here's the information on it, too. It can hold up to 12 people max. Oh, look at this monster over here. It's mounted on a trailer. Let's see if we can get inside there, but before we do, we'll go ahead and look at the Chris Craft boats here, which this is the Launch 25 GT. Okay, look at that. I love the American flag on there. That is beautiful. It's got a lot of wood grain accents on it. Pretty luxurious. Wow, shiny. Got some chrome and wood on it. I like that. Both analog and digital at the same time. Must be a Volvo Penta engine powering this monster. Same with that one. But those Chris Craft boats are huge. Those are monsters. Let's check those out. Looks like we got to take our shoes off again.
Yeah, they're good. They're going to sell it.
Whoa. Look at these monsters. This is the Launch 31 GT. 11,000 pounds. Whoa, what a beast. Also, wood grain accents on it. How are you, sir? I'm just looking around, sir. Just checking these out. These are cool.
Didn't know if I could answer questions or anything for you.
Oh, no, sir. I'm good.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, yes. What engine's in this one?
This one has the... V8 5.3 liter Volvo.
Sweet.
That's about 350 horsepower.
Okay.
Motor, yeah.
Oh, that's cool. So this one has two of them on there?
Yes, sir.
Oh, a twin engine. Now that's cool.
Yep.
Wow, this is cool. Wow. I like the the console with the driver's seats and stuff, with the computer screen and stuff, and all the wood grain accents. That's really cool.
Yep.
Was that your idea or what?
Oh, no, that's all Chris Craft.
Oh, yeah?
It's been around for about
150
years.
150 years. Oh, that explains it. And look at this. It's got truck-style air horns. That's really cool.
You have any questions?
I love this. What kind of horns are these? Did they come off of a Peterbilt or a Kenworth semi-truck? Or Freightliner?
No, it's Chris Craft's.
Oh, it's their own horn, I was going to say. Wow. Looks very much like a semi-truck horn, if you ask me. That's for sure. Wow. That's crazy. These boats are insane. We got all these wood grain accents on them. This one's got a central driving position. That looks really cool. And got some more cup holders there. Twin engine Mercuries. This one's kind of like a luxury fishing boat, I think. That's crazy. And this is a Crest pontoon. Looks like there's a chain blocking, so I don't know if you can get inside here. Maybe you could, but I don't know for sure. But it does look pretty cool in there. Let's see, maybe. I don't know what that is, but let's just see if I can. I think I can. Yeah, there we go. Okay, there we go. Wow, a lot of room up here. It's called the Crest Caribbean LX 230 SLS. Simrad computer screen right there. Crest. They also make good pontoon boats too. There's another one next to it. Wow, there are so many boat makers here, it's not even funny. Ah, and here's the staircase to get in. I completely forgot about that. And here's some information on some of them. And here's some more over here. This is called Centurion, or Centurion. I said Centurion, I butchered that really bad. Wow, it's got a canopy roof with speakers on there. And look at that. Also paddle shifters on the steering wheel. You gotta love that. That looks really cool. And right up here, you get a full bench. Right up here. A lot of that padding and speakers up there. That looks really cool. This one is the Centurion, was it FI-25? Yeah, FI-25. But wow, 200 grand for this, that's insane. Wow. That is crazy. Looks like I gotta take my shoes off to climb inside here as well. So I'm gonna go ahead. Whoa. A lot of underfloor storage in this one, as you can see. Two screens in front of the steering wheel. And look at that, the paddle shifters. I wonder how many speeds and gears it has and how fast it goes. Probably fast. That's pretty crazy. There's a big rear view mirror on this side too. That's crazy. Cintron makes pretty cool boats, and this one is Supreme over here. Somewhat similar to Cintron, if I'm not mistaken. I like the red. It's got the surfboard clips. Here's another Cintron, the FE22. 450 max torque. That's insane. And that one's got one of the screens lit up there. Look at that. And I like the paddle shifters on the steering wheel. Wow, that's insane. I like the paddle shifters on the steering wheel of these boats. How many gears does this have? How many transmission speeds?
Forward and reverse.
Just forward and reverse? And what are the paddle shifters for?
Those are to adjust speed and your center trim cap.
Oh, I was going to say. And how fast does it go, top speed?
About 37 miles an hour.
That's not too bad. Although, I do like the paddle shifters. That's kind of like a race car kind of feel to it. It's really cool.
Thank you.
Was that your idea?
No, it's not my idea.
I was going to say.
Manufacturer's idea.
Ah, well, whoever came up with it is a genius. He must be a race car driver.
He is.
I don't blame him.
Yep.
I love that. Wow.
He's a race car driver.
Wow, that's really cool. I'm a fan. I
okay,
love it.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Fun time.
Yes, sir. You too. And over here is Monterey. Got their canopy roofs on. This one's radio's going. It's a good song. Oh, wow. I love the inside of this one. This one looks really cool. Wow. Got analog gauges all around right here. Classic. That looks really cool. Got LEDs on it too, button switches. Look at that. Got a radio control switch over here on the passenger side. And there's Bayliner pontoon boats over there. I'm gonna check those out in a minute.
Any questions I can answer for you?
Wow. What engine does this one have? Okay. Wow. I like the interior of it. The interior looks great, especially the dashboard where the steering wheel is. I do like that. That looks really cool.
Do you like it well enough to take it home?
Oh, I don't know if I got the money for it, but still, you know.
Got plenty of money to go left.
But still, I'm a fan. I love it.
What kind of boat do you have now?
Well, not anymore, because we sold our lake house after my uncle passed away, but we had a Regal. That was a good one. Yeah. But I really want a diesel-powered airboat.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yep.
Enjoy the show.
Yes, sir. Monterey looks really cool. And here's a little video display of some of the Monterey boats, which is pretty cool. And then here are more pontoon boats over here. See, these are Yamaha, right over here. These are y'all Yamaha VMAX 200 and 150. And look at that, some of these come with their own inner tubes. That's pretty neat. The Sea Beast. That's what it's called. Vectra Princecraft. This one's called Jazz. That's Mercury right there. There's a lot of boats here.
That's what I think.
And look, there's the box that the inner tube comes in, the Sea Beast. This is called Veranda. Wow, look at this. Veer. What is this? Is this a motorized canoe or something? Or what is it? It's a what?
Electric outboard.
Oh, I don't know about that. That could cause some very nasty electrocutions in the water and kill you. I don't know about that. Electricity and water don't mix. That could be a very deadly combination if that some goes wrong. Because my mom told me that if you put electricity in water, you're dead. It could kill you. Yeah. I don't think I trust that. I'm sticking with gas and diesel. And this is called Princecraft. Also a pontoon boat. And this is Crestliner. This one's got a covered canopy roof with like a covered plastic to protect you from the elements. And this one's a fishing boat. It's got a trolling motor on here. Oh, you can scan to enter to win something. Oh, it's a little mini stove, I think. That's pretty cool looking. Princecraft. That one's called Vogue. Canadian DNA. It's probably made in Canada, maybe. Mercury 300 V8 in this monster. And here's where you get on these veranda boats. These are all veranda pontoons.
I actually went to the driving range there yesterday. Really.
Wow. So here's an example. The Princecraft Vectra 23RL. This is Princecraft. Also a table with cup holders. Here's its driver's seat here. Oh, analog, I like that. Now this one's really cool. Simrad computers. Got a small desk with cup holders on it. And a Bayliner right over here, the VR5. Let's go up on here. Oh, okay, I like the analog instrument cluster right there. That looks really cool. And this one's called Lund. Never heard of Lund before. It's called the Type 189. 200 horsepower, Mercury. Wow. It's got four swivel chairs, including the driver. Flat front up here. Wow, that is beautiful. These boats are crazy. You gotta love them. Now, this monster has three engines on the back of it, three Mercuries, three V10 Mercuries, 400 horsepower each. Look at that. Now, that's a monster. 1,200 horsepower and 30 cylinders all together. Look at that monster. That's insane. Let's see what this is. So, these are yachts. Or mini yachts, I think. So they're from Singleton Marine. These are called Tiara Yachts. The C39, C44, C49, EX54, EX60, that's inboard. Outboard is 34LS, 38LS, 43LS, 48LS, 34LS, LX, 43LE, and 48LE. Now let's get in this triple V10 monster and see what this is. So this is the 38LS from Tiara Yachts. Three V10s. Look at that. 30 cylinders all together, which is insane for a boat. Got a wood desk right here, and also you got to have a stove and a sink right here. What a monster. And a screen right over here.
That's why there's two tracks.
Wow. And of course, with these yachts, you have a bed inside here, which is really cool. So you can literally sleep in here. And I think in this store you have a bathroom. I think you do, but I don't know if... Actually, yeah, you do. So here you have a bathroom. So you have a sink and a toilet with a shower. Just like in one of those other yachts that I just saw back there. Wow. This is cool. These mini yachts are insane. And look at this. There's a fire extinguisher inside here. And there's a microwave inside here. More storage inside there. Here's the driver's seat.
He's who I bought my boat from. He's the one
in the center, center driving position.
So you're coming to the
with two giant computer screens from Garmin. GPS. Wow. Giant canopy roof over you.
I think they have a
with a few sunroofs in there.
And a 43.
And you can actually climb on top of here. Careful not to hit your head on the roof here because it's really close to you. You can actually grab onto this handle here to climb up here easier. It's got an air horn on top, which is really cool. So here's extra bench seating with a little desk in the middle of it and LED lights that change color. Now that's cool. You gotta love that. I can't believe this monster has three V10s. That's crazy.
It does.
That's like combining three Dodge Vipers into one monster. Or three Lamborghini Huracans. That's insane. Wow. How fast does this go?
58.
Wow, that's pretty fast for a mini yacht like this. Wow. That's crazy.
It's a beautiful boat, that's for sure.
It's a monster, especially with these V10s. You gotta love the V10. I mean, 30 cylinders all together, it's insane. These Mercuries, these are crazy. Wow.
He's the big one on the right.
Wow. And here's another one over here. This is Everglades Yamaha XTO Offshore. This one's V8, 5.6 liter, 450 horsepower each. So you get 900 horsepower, twin engine. So the center consoles are the 455cc, 395cc, 365cc, 335cc, 315cc, 285cc, and 235cc. Whereas the bay boats are the 273cc, 253cc, and 243cc. And this is the 365cc Everglades. Wow, there's a lot of room up here and a lot of storage on this one. Two GPS computers by Garmin. Center console in here. It's really neat. Giant canopy roof as well. There's the logo, 365cc. And there's that giant bench with cup holders here. You can rest up here if you so desire. There's extra seats in front of the center console. And look at this view. There's a lot of really cool boats here. There's a lot more that I haven't even seen yet. And that one's called Pursuit right over there. A little bit smaller than this, but with twin engine Yamahas as well. That's the 268S Sport from Pursuit. That looks pretty cool. I'm gonna check that out. And look at this. It also has a bathroom underneath here. Check that out. Got a toilet and a sink and a little bed, but no shower though. Still a monster. You gotta love these boats. They're insane. And now to check out the Pursuit boat over here. Here are the different models here. They have dual console, offshore, and sports center console. Wow. See what this one is. American made. Gotta love that. Yep. Also center console. Wow, look at this. And two Garmin computer screens right here. Yeah. Very ergonomic in this one. This one looks really cool. This one is the S268. Extra seating right up here. That one's the OC or offshore 246 next to us with a single engine Yamaha. And now here's the brand that my family and I are the most familiar with, Regal. So there's a lot of Regal boats over here. Beautiful American flag on this one. This one's called the Surf LS9. Volvo 380 horsepower engine. That looks really neat. Wow, huge canopy roof here. Little small wooden desk. Cup holders there. LED lights around it. That's pretty cool. Volvo Penta computers, that's pretty cool. GPS navigation. Wow. There's a bench seating here. And there's Mantara, that's a pontoon boat right over there that I'm gonna check out momentarily. Wow. And there are a lot more boats over there that I haven't even checked out yet. Wow. There are so many boats here, it's not even funny. This is crazy with all the amount of boats that there are here. It's insane. That one's called the Power Tower. This one's the Surf LS6. Also from Singleton Marine. Similar interior as in the LS9 and a lot of these other ones. Same with this one too. This one's got rear seats here on this LS6. Wow, look at this. Oh, that just looks beautiful. You gotta love that. Another Regal right over there. These Regals are pretty sweet. And this one's called the LS4, sir. And there's some people inside here already with a sales rep. Wow. Looks like they're having fun. Yeah. And next to it is Cobalt, one of Regal's main competitors. Also a surf boat. This one's called the R4 Surf. Canopy roof as well. This one's got two Garmin computers in it. Driver's seat's a little bit similar to Regal. Then again, because they're competitors. Wow, that's got a lighting roll bar on it. That's pretty cool looking on that Cobalt. This one is the R6 Surf. Wow, there's the light up LEDs on the roll bar. Surfboard holders here. Some compartments here, Garmin computers. Ah, I like the leather stitching color here on these seats here. That looks really neat looking. Cobalt and Regal are both very luxurious boats, that's for sure. This one is sold. This one is the CS23 Surf. It just sold for $135,000. Dude, that's insane. And look at that, the seat is open. Wonder what's underneath here. Is there like a thing of storage under here?
Yes.
Oh, there is. You can put a lot of stuff under there, huh? That's crazy. Wow. Ah, here's a Harris over here. It's like a pontoon. Wow, look at this. Mercury Racing 500R, which is insane. It's got a 500 horsepower in this monster. Wow, look at that interior. That looks beautiful. LEDs everywhere. Wow. That's pretty neat looking. Wow.
I don't even know why they would do that. You know, that reminds me of like Malibu back in the
Simrad day. Computers here. That looks beautiful.
Oh my god, that is awesome.
And more jet skis over here. Wow. And look at this monster. This is one of the biggest Cobalt boats here. Let's see what this is. It's called the Surfgate. And it sold as well. It's called the R33 Surf. This is a monster. I wonder how big this is. There is? Sweet. This one is the R35. Hey, like the Nissan R35 GTR, but not even close. This one's kind of like a mini yacht, if you will. I wonder what's down there. Look at that. So you can get inside there, and that's like a bed right down there. That's cool. Wow, you can sit down there, and wow. I love that. That is so cool. And there's the interior right here for the driver's seat. Wow. Phone charger there. Garmin computers. Wow. This is really cool. Now, this is a monster. This has got to be the biggest Cobalt boat ever made. I think it is. And there's more jet skis over there. They're all from Sea-Doo. I'll check those out momentarily. And more Cobalt boats over there. This one sold. Cobalt R8. Wow. These are insane. R6. R4. And CS23 again. And also, I forgot to mention that there are actually some mini yachts from Regal featured here. These are some of the biggest Regal boats ever made. I don't think Regal's ever made a boat this big before. These are monsters. And here's a little information on it. And this is like a computer screen on one of their websites with their listings. Wow. Look at these monster Regals. These are huge. Wow. I gotta see if I can get inside them if I can. Let's see. Where do you get in? Oh yeah, I think you climb up here. Whoa, look at this monster. That's like a mini yacht from Regal. Never seen that before. Wow. I gotta get inside here and check this out. However, there is a line, so I don't know if I can get in and see them all, but we'll see. But yeah, there's a decent view of them right here. Okay, so that one's called the 3300 28 Express and 33 Express and many others. But man, these mini yachts, these are huge. I don't think I've ever seen a boat this big made by Regal. These are insane. These mini yachts. Wow. They're letting just a small certain amount of people go up and see them. Wow. And they got enclosed canopies. Probably got a lot of heavy stuff on them, maybe. Got quite a bit of stuff on them too. Okay, just might as well get in line and see. Let's see. But wow, these mini yachts, they're actually really huge up close. And there's a screen, like a little TV screen, in that one over there. Whereas this one's called the Grand Coupe. And let's see what that other one is. These are all 2024s. And here, of course, you got to take your shoes off again.
You go ahead.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh.
Are you...
Huh?
How many?
Just one.
One.
All right, so I'm now up here looking at these boats here. This is the 38 Surf. Here's their screen right here, which also acts as a rear view camera, which is really cool. These are the biggest boats ever made by Regal. These are monsters. And of course, there's a stove up here with a sink. Wow, look at that. And central driving position with a rear view screen. And GPS by Garmin. That looks beautiful. And of course, it's got a storage room underneath with a bed and a bathroom. That's really cool. Let's go down here. And there's another bed right underneath there. And in here, there's a bathroom with a toilet and a sink and an enclosed shower. That's pretty cool. Wow. Because I remember my mom and dad and I and my brother, we had Regal boats at our lake house a while back, but they are not as big or as sophisticated as these. And here's some extra seating right over here. And they're having some fun.
Like that.
Yeah. That's right. Wow. These are monsters. I never thought Regal would make a boat this massive, and yet they have. And let's see this one next to it. Whoa, this canopy is almost completely enclosed. This one is the 36 Grande Coupe. Wow, look at the inside of this one. This one's pretty crazy. Wow, look at this. It's like you're in an enclosed area. I think this folds over and you get completely enclosed in here. Wow. Here's the driver's seat here. And underneath there is the bed. That looks like a queen or a king size bed. And of course, you got another bathroom. Wow, look at this. Got another bathroom with a sink and a shower. Wow. Never seen a Regal boat this big before. And there's some toiletries in there already. Already good that comes to that. And look at that. There's the bed. That looks like a queen size bed, I think. And look, there's a warning sign that says, please do not sit on bed. So, you know, you gotta make it pristine for some future buyers that wanna buy this. So you don't want it to look nasty, that's for sure. And there's more seating area right back there. Let's travel the world. Wow. Now this one's really cool. And right up here, look at this. Another beautiful view of the boat show. A lot more boats around here. More bench seating here. This is really cool. Let's see this one next to it. This one is the 33 Express. And it's got a stove on it. Gotta love the stove. And a sink. And there's a mini fridge right below the stove. That's cool. And there's the driver's seat with a central computer by Volvo Penta. And of course, with an underbody storage area.
We're waiting to get in.
Yeah, we're waiting. Okay. And yeah, it's got a bed down there too, and extra storage and extra seating there, and a bathroom as well. Wow, that's pretty crazy. This one's the 3300 over here. And look at this. There's some compartments there. And I wonder, I think this thing has a stove on it. And it does. It's got a stove on it. This one's got a Volvo Penta screen, but there's a warning here. Said the preferred media device is not currently available. Wait for it to become ready, then check the connection or choose another device on the list. And what's in here? Oh, look at that. You get a bathroom with a toilet and a sink. Now that's cool. Wow. A little bit smaller, but still pretty big. A lot of room up here. Wow. Great views up here. There's more seating right here. You gotta love these boat shows. They're just fun.
What did you guys learn about the...
My mom and dad used to have a Regal a while back.
Awesome.
We had two of them. Yeah, we had the 2100 LSR, the 2200. Those were good. Oh yeah. And here is the 28 Express, the last of these. Here's a little mini cooler in here, an igloo cooler, and a sink right in here. Volvo Penta computers here. And of course, down here we got a sink right down here, another sink, and a mini stove, and a bed right down here, microwave, extra storage, and a fuse box right over here, and a bathroom with a toilet and a shower, and another sink in there. Toilet inoperable. Someone's got to probably fix that. But other than that, it all works. Shower's actually right there on top of the sink, right next to the toilet. That's kind of interesting and weird.
Pardon me?
Excuse me, guys. You good? You gotta love these monster mini yachts. These are crazy. Exclusive show price over $1 million. Look at that. That's insane. Gotta love Regal. Wow. Not bad for the biggest Regals ever made. Wow, these are insane. Oh, and there's even a hatch right up there. I didn't see that. That's pretty cool. Wow. These mini yachts, if that's what you call them or so, these are insane. And this one's called, I think it's on Mantara or Montara. Let's see, y'all. Climb these steps here. Because this is pretty high off the ground because it's on a trailer. Canopy roof right here. Computer screen right there where the driver's seat is. Actually, it's got two canopy roofs, which is pretty cool. Not one, but two. Now, you don't really see that very often on a boat. There's a lot of seating here with cup holders. Same with the rear. There's Mercury Marine on this one. I almost lost track of how many boats there are because there are too many. There's a lot. And one of my personal favorites, Malibu. These ones are more sports boats, like racing boats. Wow. I love these monsters. Wow, I love Malibu. They're the best. You gotta love Malibu. This one's called the Wake Setter LSV. 23 LSV. Oh yeah, I gotta love Malibu boats with their sporty interiors. There's their canopy roof right there. Wow, sweet looking leather. And I love that center console driver seat layout. Well, not center console, but the driver console right there on this side. I love that. I love how this looks. Very futuristic. It's got the instrument cluster computer screen in front of the steering wheel. I love how that looks. Throttle lever right there. And there's the rearview mirror right up here coming off the roll cage. And then here is more seating and bench seating right up here. More Malibu boats right over there, which I'll check out momentarily. Ooh, in the meantime, I'll check out that one over there. That orange one looks pretty cool and colorful. This one is the 23 MXZ. Is out on this one, and this one's got a surfboard on this one too. Oh, wow. That's like a huge storage compartment right in there. You could haul all kinds of stuff in there. Wow. And that is a beautiful looking driver's seat layout. Oh, it's got two computer screens. So let's see. This one's got various configuration settings, and there's all your instruments on this screen here. Surfboard holder right there. That blue one looks pretty cool. That one's the 24MXZ. I almost said MKZ, but it's MXZ. And look, there's some surfboards and wakeboards over there. Also by Singleton Marine. Wow, that orange padding looks really cool. And it's got its radio going as well. And this is called the 2024 Access 220R, T220R. It's not a Malibu, it's an Access. It's a bit different. It's got its canopy roof out. Whoa, someone turned the radio up on one of those up to 11. Wow. What a way to jam out, right? Oh, wow, this one's pretty cool. It's got a little screen there by Garmin. In my opinion, the Malibu looks a little bit better than this, but this one's all right. Not too bad. Let's see. I have no idea how many more boats there are over there, but I gotta check more of them out. That's insane. Let's see what this pontoon's called. Barletta. Wow. Mercury Marine on this one. Barletta. Never heard of them.
229.
Wow. Barletta Reserve R26MA. That's what this one is. And it's got a desk with cup holders in there. Pretty looking interior here. Got its canopy roof out. Got the beautiful American flag right there. These ones are all Mercury Marine. This one's called the Barletta Aria. Analog instrument cluster. No computers or digital dashboards here.
Those are going to be over there. Those are the bigger ones.
Oh, this one's a little bit smaller. This one's a 22 UC Aria. Now that looks really cool. Can that act as a bed right there? Can you sleep on it?
Yeah.
Oh, sweet. Love your mustache, by the way.
Thank you.
Wow, classic. Gotta love the handlebar stash. You're rocking it good, my brother. Oh, yeah.
Wow. I'll give you the bad visual.
Wow.
I don't work here, but you can pay me anyway.
Oh, that's okay. I'm on YouTube, so, yeah.
There's your bed.
Wow, that's cool. Thank you.
But the animals, we would have that back thing closed. We just wouldn't let them go back.
That's cool. I like this. This is cool. Thank you. Yeah. Wow. More Barletta pontoons. Oh, that one's got multiple seating. This one's the Lusso 23 UC. Looks pretty neat. Whereas this one is the Lusso 23M and the Lusso 23 QCSS. Wow. So many different options over here. Wow. It's pretty cool. I love these monsters. They're fun.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, yeah. Mercury Marine Power, too. You gotta love that.
You got it.
Yeah, brother. Oh, yeah. I am almost to the end, I think. There is a lot to look at here. I'm trying to get better camera angles and stuff, but then again, keep in mind that I need to watch where I'm going, so it's a little hard to do so. I like your hair. It looks very pretty.
Thank you.
Yours too.
Thank you.
Wow. Oh, what's this? A little spin the wheel thingy, huh?
Uh-huh, but the bag isn't on the wheel.
Oh, no. That's not good. Probably should try and win that. Wow. Probably should. And there's some wakeboards over here. That's pretty cool. Wow. And this one's Raballo. Or Rabolo, I don't know how that's pronounced, but that's like a fishing boat. Yamaha XTO offshore engine, V8 power, 5.6 liter. Kind of like a fishing boat, as some of the other fishing boats around here. And you can see it's got a trolling motor right here at the front. Minn Kota Tarova trolling motor with a propeller on there here. There's more wakeboards and inner tubes right over here. Oh, this one's got a Mercury V8 at the rear. That's pretty cool. On these Barletta pontoons. And here are more Yamaha jet skis, wave runners. A lot of these. Yeah. This brings it back to the good old days. I used to have the FX Cruiser. That was a fun beast to ride. Oh, yeah.
How you doing, sir?
Good, how are you? I used to have a Yamaha FX Cruiser a while back. It was an 06 model. It was fun.
Yeah.
Back in my lake house before we sold it.
Yeah.
But, yeah, those were good times. I heard, there's a Kawasaki one with that's supercharged with over 300 horsepower, which is crazy.
Yeah.
Have you heard of that one? That's a monster. Are there any Yamahas or any of that are supercharged or a Sea-Doo?
Yeah, so this GP SVHO is supercharged. The FX SVHO and SVHO are all supercharged.
Whoa, how much horsepower they got?
How much horsepower? 250 horsepower.
Oh, okay. Wow, and how fast does it go? Wow, I love this. This is fun. Supercharged. You gotta love that. Wow. That's pretty neat. I'm a fan. Wow.
If you have any questions, anything you want to know, please let me know. Happy to help.
Oh, yes, sir. Thank you. And what's your name, sir?
Yusuf.
Steven.
Nice to meet you.
You too. Thank you, sir. Wow, this is supercharged. Dude, that's so cool. That's supercharged. And there's Sea-Doo RXPX 325. It's got a Rotex engine. And it's also supercharged. Wow, what a monster. It's probably more powerful than Kawasaki's version, I think. Wow. 325 horsepower on this monster. That is insane. Wow. Look at this. Was it your idea to put a supercharger on this? I wonder whose idea it was.
Probably BRB's.
Oh, wow. That's fun. You gotta love the supercharger. All that extra boosties. You gotta love that. Wow, I can't believe this is supercharged. You gotta love that. This one is the Wake 170. 170 horsepower NA. Naturally aspirated. Sea-Doo. Wow. It's got a little mast unit on the back. Probably to attach a surfboard or something. Or a wakeboard.
I was like, hey, like,
This one is the GTI SC130/170. 130 horsepower to 170 horsepower. Wow. And it's got speakers on it with a radio and Bluetooth. That's cool. Wow. Spark tricks. So this could probably be used for like making random tricks. And this is only 90 horsepower, but it's light. 900cc. Another Sea-Doo. RTX 325 again. Supercharged. Wow. So crazy that this is supercharged. It's got radio speakers on either side. That's crazy. A supercharged jet ski. That's hella fun. And here is Yamaha's engines right here. Here's more of Yamaha's engines. Here's the Yamaha 75 or F75. Four-cylinder, 1.8 liter, four-stroke. F90, which is a 1.8 liter four-cylinder as well. Also four-stroke. These are all four-strokes. And F115, which is also a 1.8 liter four-cylinder. And here is the 150, which is either a 2.7 liter or a 2.8 liter inline four cylinder. Very popular one here. This one's the VMAX. VMAX 90 or VF90. Also a four cylinder. And VF115, also 1.8 four cylinder as well. Here's the Show VMAX 200, or VF200, which is a 4.2 liter V8. Actually, no, V8. V6, actually. But it does have a similar displacement as the low displacement V8, so you get that. This one's also a V6, 4.2 liter, 250 horsepower, VF250. And these are all the different propeller blades for different boats. These ones are for the large monster boats. Saltwater Series XL, XTO OS, Saltwater Series 2, Saltwater Series XL4, Saltwater Series XL4 HP. Wow. Saltwater Series HS4. And the offshore one. And here is a diagram of the inner workings on how the propeller shaft works, which is really cool. You can see the gears mesh together to make the propeller run, which is really cool. Over here are for the medium and smaller boats. This is Reliance. Telon SS4 or SDS. Performance 3, Quest, Talon SS, Talon GP, Aluminum, and here's its cutaway as well. Wow. Beautiful setup on all these engines. I love them. These are beautiful. Wow. Oh, look at that. These are some of the smaller ones, too. This one's a 2.5. This is a pull start on it. Same with this one. That's a 4. This one's a 4-stroke. 15 and 9.9. Here's information. This is F2.5. It is a single cylinder. And this one is also a single cylinder. This one's 139cc, whereas this one is 72cc. And F15, that is a two-cylinder. Also a four-stroke. Throttle lever on each of these three here. And this is T9.9, high thrust four-stroke. It's also a two-cylinder, 212cc per cubic centimeter. Whereas this one is portable four-stroke. These are all portable four-strokes. These are really cool for like little mini boats or projects. And here is the instrument cluster of many Yamaha boats, including the steering wheel here, throttle control, all the kinds of cool gadgets and gizmos here. And this shows you on how to operate it. That's really cool. So you can move the steering wheel if you want, like this. Throttle lever. If you have two engines, you can do one at a time or all together simultaneously. And this is joystick docking, which is what this is right down here. You can set your point. This also is autopilot, which is kind of different and interesting. Although I don't really trust autopilot on a boat. Not really. More Yamaha engines over here. This one is the F70. 1,000cc four-cylinder. F60, 1,000cc four-cylinder as well. F40, which is a three-cylinder, 750cc. And F30, another three-cylinder, 750cc as well. Complete with their propellers as well. And look at this. This one is the XTO Offshore V8 5.6 liter monster, the XF450. Wow, look at that monster. That's insane. And there's Yamaha Reliable Rigging Solutions. It's pretty neat. And look, they have desk tables with their star logo on there too. Was it your idea to make these tables like that?
Not all.
I was going to say, it looks pretty and stylish. Oh, it's a tuning fork, not a star logo. I mean, it almost looked like a star kind of, but yeah, definitely a tuning fork. Because Yamaha, you know, they tune musical instruments and even motorcycles as well. And the Lexus LFA was also tuned by Yamaha as well. And I have some of Yamaha bikes in my Ride 4 and Ride 5 motorcycle sims. And they're really fun. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're monsters. They really are. Wow. Here's more. Skeeter. It's called the Skeeter. Also Yamaha as well. Oh, wow. Giant computer screen right there where the driver's seat is. Wow. All digital here. That's pretty neat. Complete with trolling motor. Wow. Skeeter. Wow.
Not here yet, this one.
This one's the ZX200. There's its trolling motor. Yeah. This is a tribute to my late Uncle Spence, since he used to do fishing a lot, and he had his own fishing boat that was Honda powered. He used to take my brother and I fishing a lot. But when he passed, you know, that was a bummer. So this is a tribute to my late Uncle Spence, since he did fishing a lot back in his time, as well as hunting. There's another fishing boat. It's a smaller one, G3. This one's called the Gator Tough 17. G3, center console operated. Pretty basic and simple. And this one is the G3 Deluxe 17. Yeah, a lot more fishing boats over here. If my Uncle Spence was still alive, he would love to see this. Because this is what he did back in his time. This was his pastime that he did. And these G3 boats are pretty cool. I think if he were still alive today, he would love to see these. Definitely. And they're playing cornhole over there. Look at that. It's hard to believe that's actually a competitive sport now. There's a little empty space area. Kids playing around over there. And look at this. They're doing face painting over here. And they have a giant Lego set over here with giant Lego bricks. Wow, that's pretty cool. There's a lot of outdoor lawn chairs over here. And here's Moomba. These Moomba boats, the Moomba Mojo. This one's pretty cool looking. Now, there's no ladder to get in there, unfortunately, but you can get a good look at it. It's got wakeboards on it. Here's a little mini truck, Japanese mini truck with a driver's seat on the wrong side. I think it's a Honda or something. This one is JL Audio. Wow, this one looks really cool. I like the computer screen right there where the driver's seat is. And right over here are more Garmin audio accessories for various boats. That's pretty cool. They got their own booth there. Wow, look at that. Malibu again. Love Malibu boats. And also Mastercraft. This is the very first Mastercraft ever built. Wow. Basic and simple. Wow. That looks beautiful. And this is the X26. Whoa, here's the canopy roof. It's a little low, so I gotta bend under. Get underneath it. There we go. Wow. Whoa, what's in here?
It's just a storage area really right now.
Oh, that's cool. Can you put like a bathroom in there, like a little toilet or so if you so desire?
Yeah, if you wanted to.
That'd be cool.
Film me though. I appreciate it, Doug.
Wow, this is cool. I like the instrument cluster. Totally get it. The digital instrument cluster, that looks really cool.
Yeah, it is.
Was that your idea?
No. I'm not with Mastercraft. As far as I'm Whiskey's brief, I don't engineer the Mastercraft side of things.
I was going to say, yeah.
Get the dash.
Yeah. This is really cool. And I like this setup as well. You get two screens like that.
So what do you think?
I really like how that looks. That just looks cool.
Want to go to a boat this big?
And there's more seating right up there. Mastercraft is really cool.
Yeah.
Very configurable. There's another one right on the side here. And as you can see, there's LED lights blinking and flashing all over. So as you can see, there's some LEDs on this one over here and a wakeboard. Oh, look at this. And this is like a metal flake style paint job. That's pretty cool looking. Wow, this looks really cool. There's its canopy roof with its LED light, speakers on it. Wow, look at that. Great view up here. Really good view. Look at that. Mastercraft makes really cool looking boats too. Wow.
It's down low by the water level.
This interior just looks really good. I like that instrument cluster right there at the driver's seat. That looks really cool. There's no passenger seat here because you get a bench facing the other way. That's really cool. That's all right. Wow, great view over here. So yeah, these are the Mastercraft boats. This one is the X-Star S. 268 grand, dude, that's crazy. But for that price, might be worth it. Yeah, Mastercraft makes cool stuff. This one is the X-22. Wow, that is crazy. Oh, this one's got half metal flake, half regular paint on it. Kind of like a two-tone style. That's pretty cool. This one is the XT-22 with the silver and the blue on it. That looks really cool. That looks pretty neat. Wow. That throttle control lever just looks cool. And these digital instrument clusters look really neat too. Wow. And there's a big rearview mirror right here on this side too. And there's more pontoon boats right over here. Oh, I like this red one over here. This is the XT25. Wow. Now that looks beautiful. I love the red on this one. The red looks great. Here's the XT24. NXT24. Oh wow, that one looks a little bit different on the inside. I'll show you how this thing looks. Oh wow. This one looks really neat. Slightly different layout here on the driver's seat area. Different screen here. And here is the NX23 Rule the Water Tour. That's pretty cool. Let's see if we can get that a better view of inside there. Wow, that looks really cool. But I actually like the other dashboard configuration slightly better. But those are a lot of the Mastercraft boats. And there are more pontoon boats over here. These ones are called Sylvan. So these are from Sylvan. Oh, look at this monster. 400 horsepower in this monster here, the G5 CLZ DC. Wow, look at this. A lot of wood in here. Simrad computer screen in there. A sink right here. That's pretty cool. Mercury Marine engine. And they got wakeboards over there. This one is the L3 CLZDH, 400 horsepower to 350 horsepower. Wow. And that's got a little desk there with cup holders. You gotta have that. And they got their canopy roofs up with LED lights on them. That's pretty cool. You gotta love that. All analog driver's seat here. No screen here, like on that one right there next to us. Same with that one too. These ones are all Mercury Marine powered. Gotta love Mercury Marine. This one is the S3 LZ, 250 to 300 horsepower. I like that Simrad computer screen there. That looks good. There's the desk with the cup holders in there. And what is this? Is that a grill right there?
It's
or
a bar.
Oh, it's a bar.
And it folds down into a sun pad.
Wow. Well, let's see what we have here. Yeah, let's see what this has.
So you'll have to move that chair to fold it down.
John, move your chair.
Oh, yeah?
Move your beer.
Oh, wow. So this transforms. This turns into
kind
things.
Kind of wiggle That's, it out.
Wow. Yeah. Kind of like a transformer. It turns into things. That's pretty cool. Whoa. It folds out into like a... like an extra set of bench seating. Now that's cool. Dude. And it's got bar stools too. Hence why it's a bar. Wow. That's crazy. Never seen that before on a boat.
We call this the stabbing cabin.
Huh? Oh, wow. You okay? Wow.
Dude,
that's crazy. Wow. An outdoor bar on a boat. That's crazy. That is huge. Looks like some extra storage right underneath there. So if you have anything that you need stored, you store anything right underneath there.
Like you could ride somewhere, like go on a trip with a boat with our boats.
Yeah, you could store anything out there. Yeah, there's probably more storage down there too. Yeah, you just open that, and there's no stairs. Nope. But if you go in the monster yachts, then those have stairs, and they have bathrooms inside them too, and bedrooms too. So over there, if you go over there to where Regal and stuff is,
to go to the bathroom in there?
I don't know for sure, but you can look at it. You can check it out, but it's really cool though. You should check it out. That they're in those mini yachts.
Maddie, you put skis down in there.
Yeah.
Water
skis. A future boat owner right here. You want your own boat one day?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, future boat owner right here. Yeah. That's parenting done right.
Exactly.
Wow. That's right. Keeping the boat industry alive.
Where's the downstairs?
There's no downstairs on this one. And here are Bennington pontoon boats. This one's sold here. This one's a 24... 2 SSVSR SPS Tritune. It's got the desk on there with cup holders. Huh. Half analog, half digital instrument cluster. Pretty cool. Canopy roof right up there. Yamaha engine. That one's the Bennington L23 next to us with the beautiful American flag. Hell yeah, brother. And there's one of the pontoon tubes on display, which is really cool. Got some info on it. So there's a little pontoon tube on display. Ooh, one of the radios on one of those boats over there is cranked up to 11. So yeah, these are Bennington. Bennington is another very prestigious maker of pontoon boats. And over here is Moombaugh and Supra. So here's Supra. It's not the Toyota Supra, that's for sure.
Oh, that's cool. So you can see the
it's the Supra boat.
Oh, that's awesome. Oh,
oh now that's cool.
Yeah,
what
that's
is
like brilliant.
What's this?
So this is that's for the prep people,
power,
like me.
Power
like,
drop
I can't get
my Supra.
Oh, wow.
Wow. So you can't push yourself up on that platform. You just step and you walk out of the water like, hey, Zeus.
Wow. The Toyota Supra is nothing compared to this. Exactly, because that's what it's called. So here's the other Supra. Here's inside of this. It's got a lot of stuff inside there, a lot of wood grain in there. It's pretty cool. pretty cool right down there. Wow. It's got surfboard holders on this one. And there's a little jumpy thing for little kids to get in there.
Also, it's a very light.
And here's little speakers and cup holders on both sides. LEDs that change color on the floor. It's pretty cool. And there's another platform right here for extra seating. Here's a big rearview mirror right here. Here's the driver's seat with similar digital displays to Mastercraft and Malibu. That looks absolutely beautiful. Hard to believe it's called a Supra. Wow. And there's the Moomba right over there. There's more storage right in that one too. And there's Moomba right over here. Moomba. It's called the Taycan. I think that's what it's called. The Raptor by Moomba. Similar to the Supra boat, if you will. It's got its canopy roof out. Swivel seat for the driver. Wow, there's a little cupboard right in front of the steering wheel to store your stuff, if you have any. And it also has paddle shifters right behind the steering wheel. Look at that. How cool is that? You gotta love that. That's pretty neat. Another rearview mirror right here. Another screen right here, a small screen. And that probably just about wraps up the boat show. What a wonderful display of boats this is. You gotta love these boats. They're beautiful. All right, looks like that's about everything for the 2024 Atlanta Boat Show. Feel like I saw everything. Now, I apologize if my camera angles were a little bit low, because then again, you know, I have to watch where I'm going and stuff. And maneuvering around these boats can be a little tricky, so please keep that in mind. So I'm trying to make sure that we get a pretty good view of these boats or whichever we can. So I got a lot of complaints about that last year, so I'm trying to work on that. But other than that, I feel like I got some pretty good footage of these boats. And if there's any particular boat that you like, or anyone that you want to know about, type in the comments below. I especially love these monster regals. These are insane. I love the fact that they brought mini yachts here. These mini yachts are really cool. Every boat here is just amazing. You gotta love it. Life on the water can be just as enjoyable as life on land. Boats have literally come a long way from centuries ago. And now they have a lot more technology and sophistication and luxury than cars. It's like they're rivaling that of cars a little bit. It's crazy. But yeah. These boats are crazy. And I know that my mom and dad love boats as well. And I love boats also, as well as cars. And of course, there's a lot more boats here than cars, because when the auto show comes around, I got a feeling there probably won't be as many cars or trucks here as there are boats. But that is to be expected. That probably explains why boats could be a lot more enjoyable than cars at some points. But still, boats are still amazing pieces of engineering. If you want to move on the water at high speed and in style, boating is usually the best way. Hope you all enjoyed the 2024 Atlanta Boat Show. Then again, I apologize about some of my camera angles that I've had because, you know, there's a lot of people here and a lot of boats, so I have to maneuver around without hitting anybody or falling over. So just got to be really, really careful in these areas. So then again, hope you all enjoyed. And I might be here for the Atlanta Auto Show, but we'll see what happens with that. But other than that, boat show turned out great. It was awesome.